Management are here, and I heard the chairman of the occasion is equally here, and the guest lecturer is also here. So there's nothing keeping us from kicking off with the program. But our choir, our students' choir, wants to give us a very brief rendition to tune up the spirit to the energy we need for this wonderful but painful occasion. It's not every time a man dies at 80. You say he has gone too soon. But in Professor Mbonu's case, most of us feel he left too soon. It's a rare one. Choir, please. See if you can console us enough and put us in the energy we need for today's event. While they are getting ready, I think the chief medical director is around. And the hospital management are here. Protocol, can you kindly let them in? This serves as their procession song. So leading the procession is our chief medical director, Professor J.O. Obaja. Please come to the high table. Following him is the chairman of the event, Professor Gashom Ejekam, a veteran, a close associate of Emeritus Professor Ounbonu, a teacher of many of us, and one of the fathers of pathology in this part of the world. No wonder I can see Professor Onyora basking around like he's still a school pupil because his father is in our midst. The guest lecturer too is here, Professor P.I.S. Okafor. Ichie Buruburu, Mabando Wanine, who is going to tell us about our father. And Chief Chudi, Chudi Okoli, representing the state governor, I'm sure that his presence in our midst, because he's the accountant general of the Anambra State. Chief Chudi, you're welcome. Your roots are from here. So now we're going to manage to talk. Come Imam Egbedu with the bundle. If anything. So you're welcome. Without further ado, the program takes off immediately with the protocols. Let me recognize the chairman of today's event, Professor Gashom Ejekam, who is a contemporary, a friend, and one of the younger colleagues of Professor Ounbonu. Professor Ejekam, you are welcome. Let's appreciate him. Let us recognize the chief hosts of today's event, the chief medical director of Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital, Professor J.O. Ubaja, Ochinawata Ndi Newi. Echekwa Mewo, Ochinawata Owanini, Afu Newi. You're welcome. Let me recognize the Provost of the College of Health Sciences of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Professor G.O. Udigwe, to kindly come up to the high table. The West African College of Surgeons, whose president, Emeritus Professor O. Mbono, once was, has sent a major representative in our midst. And let me call on to the high table immediately the representative of our college, the West African College of Surgeons, Professor A.M. Iwonfo. Is equally the coordinating chairman of all the local organizing committees for this funeral and a son, professional son of Emeritus Professor O. Mbono, past provost of our college, past dean, head of surgery, and the CMAC. He was the chairman medical advisory committee to Professor O. Mbono and acting CMD in the days of yore. Let's appreciate him, please. At this juncture, let me call a representative of Professor O. Mbono's family. Let me call Mr. and Mrs. Obiora Mbono to come up to the high table, please. We want to feel the spirit of your father physically, because today is a day of transition for us. Suddenly, we have to refer to our immortal CMD in the past tense of was. So with you on that table, I think he's here with us too. Let me call the chairman of Medical Advisory Committee of Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital to kindly come to the high table. Professor Ogo Ezechofo. Okwula Oka, that's what they call him. He stands to intimidate. He stands to intimidate everybody. Any more seats at the high table? Well, a lot of other recognitions will come as we create more space on the high table. So on that note, if we turn over to program brochure page number 10, you could see the protocols. We want this to be very crisp, very direct, because we got a lot to do ahead of us. But let me recognize the presence of great men of academics who are here with us. Professor J.I.B. Adema, I can see you, past provost. Aha. If you look at, if you look at the entrance door, a deity is taking his step forward. Bring him straight to the high table. Igwe Peter Anugu, Eza Amusu, the Igwe of Mbuku. Emeritus Professor O. Mbono is one of his closest confidants, and they worked over the past 50 years together. They went through thick and thin. Even the time when he was the CMD, Igwe Anuku was like his guardian angel. Ezamusu, Anya Ekene, Ekene Ifene Angel Gozi. No, because let's appreciate him powerfully. He's deeply rooted in us, because even the current medical director of the Federal Medical Center, Onisha, is one of his offsprings. Let's appreciate him, please. His wife is his wife. Igwe Isegenosa. And let's recognize in no particular order. I can see, I don't know who is having a mask, but you have to forgive me if I jump over. Let me recognize Mr. and Mrs. Obumneme Chinenye Mbono, Professor Mbono's dad. I still can see, oh, the DA, Chief Mrs. Uche Ugochukwu, I call her UCH, the Director of Administration of Nnamdi Azikiwe University. Let's appreciate her, please. You know, there is this new strain of COVID that it doesn't give any sign to kill. And when you get to levels as high as the Director of Admin, you have to lead by example. So let's appreciate her and the fact that she's wearing a mask and following the rules of WHO. Close to her is a professor. Mago Mwazina, Abuchakwa professor now. Owebonde Malunukuma. Gozie Ifadike, Deputy CMAC. Let's appreciate her. Professor of Community Medicine. And I come over, I can see Professor MC Nwosu, former Dean of the Faculty of Medicine. Professor Nwosu, please. Thank you, sir. Professor SNN Nwosu, former Dean of our faculty too, ophthalmology. Professor CCS Echukwu, former Dean and Provost, former Provost of the College of Health Sciences. Let's appreciate him. And the stalwart of the College, the West African College of Physicians, and working closely, even with our sister college, West African College of Surgeons. CC, please, let's appreciate him. And close to him is somebody who is their elder, because he's retired before all of them. It doesn't matter who thought the other was professor first. Gabriel Chianakwana, professor of surgery. You see, the applause shows that Imago Pharaoh Namarozi Joseph Ebidogo Ochichi, before this house would have gone down from the roof. Gabriel, you're welcome, sir. And close to him is another retiree elder statesman, Professor J.C. Orapwe, all of whom were trained by Professor Ombona. And next is our own dear, lovely Professor, Mrs. Ifeoma Egbuonu, that is West African College of Physicians. You know, if you see West African College, there has been no president like her, and she broke all records. And she's our mother of pediatrics here, and one of the pioneer staff of the Nnamdi Azikiwe University Hospital. Now, sitting by him is director of our oncology, cancer, especially cancer concerning breasts, senology. Professor S.N.C. Agnawo, who has been dean of our faculty and a permanent feature in the organogram of the College of Health Sciences and University. Yes. And to his left is Professor Mrs. Dolly Echendu Ademma, Professor of Community Medicine. Sorry about that. Then, in no particular order, I see Professor Joy Benebe, Professor of Pediatrics, whom you should know well. Please, let's appreciate you. I can see Professor W.C. Igwe, Professor of Pediatrics, a neurologist. I can see her, Professor A.O. Igwebe, past Chief Medical Director, immediate past Chief Medical Director of Nnamdi Azikiwe University Hospital. And I can see, let's appreciate our CMD. Then close to him is Professor P.U.L.A. Professor L.A. has been acting Dean, acting CMD of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, and a senior citizen pulmonologist who retired as a professor of internal medicine. Close to him, next to him, is Professor Glad Ahaneko. I'm sure all of you know him. Well, unfortunately, we're in a mourning period. Otherwise, Ako Onoko will bring back peculiar dues. The way you people are going, because this is not what I expect. Please, let's appreciate her again. Now, a very iconic gentleman at that head. I mean, he's the only one that looks like he is. Who is an icon? An icon is a person or an object or a figure that has no imitation and is representative of whatever they say it is and full of reverence. I mean, there's a hair you will see, you say, this is like this man. I'm sure none of you know him. Most of you may not know him. But this is Professor Victor Anosa. He's a professor of pathology. He started here. He was here before, but he was equally University of Ibadan. So you can see how the spirit moves. Wherever you hear that we have lost Professor Ombono, everyone wants to rush in to come and pay his last respects. I can see Walter Kwacha, one of our foundation pharmacists in now. Walter Kwacha, please let you be, yes. It is a thing of honor to realize that he is a senior citizen. And when Professor Anosa came in here, the first person he recognized was Walter Kwacha. Walter Kwacha. Then next to him is our deputy provost, Professor Jatex Ejatulukwalo Obi. Deputy provost, sir, we welcome you. And the one and only that has not more than one initial, Uwakwe, Professor Richard Uwakwe, the professor of mental health. And then, the choir here represents Kwigwene Webao. Yes. And I am my high table. We have our own professor, Obiola Ase, in our midst. Let's appreciate him. Please, professor of pediatrics. Then, next to him is Professor Ivy Onyora, who is. It will be difficult to get everybody here for us to get started, but I will not move on without mentioning Ogo Ejiofor, Professor of Medicine. He's the endocrinologist. He's another man mountain, Okulo Oka. So if you don't clap for him for who he is, you clap for him for the man mountain he is. Let's appreciate it. And when we are here, our eyes, one kind worker. So what I do, as I keep picking, I can see Zonta Phobis in our midst. Zonta on the final, Professor Bono Kulolombo. I can equally see Professor Eze in our midst. Professor Eze, our past dean. I can see Chief Mrs. Nonye Onye Jiaka, who is the pioneer principal of the School of Nursing, Nnamdi Azikiwe University Hospital. And she was the person that designed the curriculum and the protocols for the first College of Nursing Sciences in Anambra State, in Amichi. Let's appreciate. And she is the mother of our deputy CMAC. Let's appreciate. Why is Ulezu? Then close to him is Professor T.O.G. Chukwuanuku. Please, if I skip you, I will return to you. At this age and at this distance, Ifemel Woke. Let's appreciate T.O.G. Immediate past head of surgery and combined board of surgery. And I can see Professor C.K. Oranwusi too. Let's appreciate him. And Dr. C.O. Nduku. So we keep moving. The DC Max are all here. Where is Dr. Odili? Aloyo Odili Okoye. And I'll keep picking you. Okay, he's standing. So that done or partially done, the chairman of this event is Professor Gashom Ejekam, a renowned pathologist of all times, and one of the few we saw who came in from Canada in the days when we were still babies in school. And he's here today to be the chairman of this very vital event. Professor, sir, chairman, may I kindly hand over the microphone for you to take over the proceedings? Is there any clergyman to say an opening prayer for us? Igwe mbuku amama aya go for ka ye pe pele sa eza mo su nya I permission anya mele jebe
eh Because I'll seek permission to keep seated. Who will legal alignment? The next thing we have here is opening prayer. MC, I believe that you sourced whoever is going to pray.
Yes, sir. I can ask canal permission from Ezra Musu. I get peno dona na ke penoka. If o ku skeme. Ask ke peno ibo ke peku enko ka. Igwe Ezra Musu igwe. Ezra Musu igwe kwazo. Let me call on Professor Joy Ebenebe to come and say an opening prayer for us. O kan ozikwe ai. Professor Ebenebe. On the I guess now the born again or the original.
Shall we pray? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Our dear Heavenly Father, most excellent Creator and Possessor of heaven and earth, we worship you and honor you. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for bringing all of us together to this place without any evil report. We commit the activities of this day into your hands. We have gathered to give honor to whom honor is due, to begin the payment of last respects to our most excellent teacher, our academic father, and so on and so on. We pray that you will guide us throughout our stay in this place, that at the end, every honor and glory will be ascribed unto you. We ask that our academic father's soul will rest in peace. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed.
Thank you very much, Professor Joy Ebenebe. The chairman has requested that the opening prayer taken, may we all stand up and take the national anthem. Very much. May we be seated. So may we take the chairman's opening remarks.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, like I said before, I seek permission to sit as I read my comment. I would have just liked to just make casual comments on this, but okay, it's a family member of mine, and I want to have on record what I have to say. I've tried to observe some protocols, but if anyone is missed that, please, this has been written before now. Our chief host, medical director, Professor Joseph Ogbaja, Ochinawata Newi OON. The CMAC, Professor Ogoi Zejofo, one guy by Mok Badi Mimo. Members of the hospital management team, members of the hospital community of Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital, Newi, colleagues, seniors and juniors, the Igwes, the press corps, the Mbono family members here present, ladies and gentlemen, I solemnly welcome you all to today's event with a very heavy heart, and we all know why. Firstly, let me thank the organizers of today's event for the great honor done to me by nominating me to chair this very memorable event, a public lecture in honor of my very good friend, Emeritus Professor Oke Obiora Mbono. Thank you. I thank God Almighty for bringing all of us here safely today, and I do pray that we all return safely back to our respective homes after the events. How I wish the circumstances were different and the triggering event a joyous one. However, in all situations, we are admonished to keep hope alive and to give thanks to God for everything. We are gathered here today to give honor to whom honor is due. Okay, as I was privileged to call him, despite his seniority in age and profession, attained great heights in life and in ranks of medical profession, not by intrigues and negotiation, but by hard work, diligence, brilliance, perseverance, honesty, and unparalleled integrity and humility. Professor Kemborn, without any preliminaries, no complaints, and no doctor's visit, departed this world and returned to his creator a while ago. An ego has flown home. While this has been very hard to take in, we equally have a duty to keep the flame he lit burning. Today and now, a public lecture is going to be given in his honor. I therefore, without much ado, implore us all to be ready to listen, absorb, assimilate, and digest the facts that epitomize the life of our friend, father, husband, family member, teacher, and senior colleague, Emeritus Professor Oo Mbono. I'm glad that a giant in field of medicine, a surgeon, and especially urologist, Professor P.I.S. Okafor, has been chosen to deliver this lecture. I therefore invite us all to relax and enjoy the talk. To God be the glory. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Please, let's appreciate the chairman profoundly. Thank you very much, chairman. We are getting on. We are going to take the welcome speech of the CMD, then the brief citation of the special public lecturer. And I hope that the reader of the citation is very much around with us. Let me appreciate the members of the high table once again, the chairman, Professor Gashom Ejekam. Ejekam is with a CK, not just a K. And that is over 3 decades right now. And next to him is the CMD of NAU, Professor J.O. Ogbaja. Ochinawata Ndinewi. He can only find a man.
Run the age proper and ladan.
Anaga.
Emakwa. The chairman of today's occasion, Professor Jacob, when you get permits, we have no work order today. But as well, the guest lecturer for the day, Bakbando, I recognize you. The provost, Akuruno, and the deputy provost, I recognize you, Jates. The His Royal Majesty now, Miss Iguanoku, is almost. Thank you for coming. Man, I cook against it, but against Hana. And you go dig 5 minutes notice that you must come. Wow. Because I'm old. Thank you for making our time to come. Thank you for also supporting my friend as the MD of the FMC on Echebele. Dalu Naki Nenyevi. The immediate past CMD of the teaching hospital, Professor Igwebe, my father and a mentor that also introduced me into the hospital management, Prof. Dal Ifembokbo, the Accountant General of Anambra State, a major stakeholder in the teaching hospital, who was a head of our accounts unit and was part of the team that transformed the hospital, Chief Chukwu Odiokoli. Ebeje Jog, thank you for coming to honor OO. The chairman of the committee that has been mobilizing, including fundraising, to ensure that Emeritus Professor OO Mbonu receives a befitting rite of passage, Professor Nwafo Enenubak, thank you for what you've done. The members of the family of late Emeritus Professor OO Mbonu, I recognize you. Check Chinoye. Dalun, you've worked very hard and it's coming to an end. So Jisike. The members of the management team of the teaching hospital, led by Okulo Akana Youths, Professor Ogeze Jofo, I recognize you. All the DA, Ms. Ugochukwu, very humble and unassuming, Najisike, all our deputy CMAX, Samoa, it's in DC Mark now, was in Omaka. I brought today Kubido with me. I was made a DC Mark 2 years after my fellowship. And then Danny Nefulebe and we go many years after their fellowships. So all the DC Marks here, I recognize you. Dalun, for what you've doing for Nayut. My personal chief of staff, Jackson, I recognize you. Thank you for coming around. I want to recognize all the heads of departments here and then the professors. But permit me to recognize specifically the retirees here. I'm excited. Ifunu, Afumorakwe, Fugabru, Fuele, for MC, then for Buonadife, Norifite. I have said, and I want to repeat it, Nayada Puafunanayut. If the university can do Emeritus Professor for life, there's no reason why the teaching hospitals cannot do. Oh, Febekonebido. And so, Onye Obuna retired from Nayut and is still strong enough to add to what we are doing in terms of coaching the young ones, in terms of offering services, in terms of contributing to research, who have a place to perform. That's what I said. And in year 2024, we are going to put pen to paper. Onye Aderoma, Obosi Ochibolo, Meko Sitiamma, this is what I want to do. Yes. The members of the MD Canesco, led by the chairman Victor, I recognize you. And I'm making ending in Abiraba because maybe protocol. The protocol has been well established by the MC. SNC, I am. So, see, Pwezie, let me rest on the existing protocol, but not without recognizing all the other members of MDCAN and our students, and friends and well-wishers of the family, friends and well-wishers of the hospital. So, today marks the beginning of the series of events line up to ensure that late Emeritus Professor Mbono receives a befitting final rites from us as an institution. And so we are starting today with the public lecture. Tomorrow we have the commendation service and we'll follow up through until the burial proper and the final rites proper. This is not the time for tributes. It must be mentioned. He was an astute administrator and an accomplished academician. He was an Iroko. Yes. And more importantly to us as an institution, he was the architect of the new Nayut. Yes, he was the architect of the Nayut as we see today. And not only midwifing the hospital we have today, he stayed close to us throughout. He kept inspiring us, kept encouraging us, kept guiding us. Onwere Obosi, Gabia here, on and on my office. And he will not come and say hi, you know. Despite I born, even while I was CMAC under Prof. Sigwebe, he usually will come around and see Prof. I will not mind being one, but Prof will go and see him anytime he's here. Ibiakwa, you know, Omenko Jinolia. He had answers to almost all our administrative challenges. Onweki he sibegike. Kibe mite oo. As a CMD, or even as a CMAC, kogari inyegi lee way out, or inyegi a roadmap, ikeji gapuna de problem. On a personal note, he was my greatest cheerleader as a CMD. Yes. Even in the days while I was not sure of many things, especially with respect to the permanent site project, he stood behind me. In fact, he was the person that gave me the inspiration and the encouragement and told me that it can be done. Like I said, it's not time for tributes, but let me welcome all of us to today's event. Kanataba. I want to especially thank our chairman for today's event, Professor Jikam, Prof. Dalu, for accepting to chair this particular occasion. I want also to thank the guest lecturer for the day, Professor Pia Isokafo, for agreeing to give the lecture, even with the short notice we gave you, Bapondo Dalu Rina, for coming. I want to appreciate everyone who has been working hard to ensure that OO receives a befitting passage right he deserves. I want to pay tribute to the committee led by Professor Nwofu Enerbach Dalon for all you've done. But on a special note, I want to appreciate our own NAIUT committee that's put up together this particular event and subsequent events you're going to be witnessing. The committee is led by the CIMAC and the DA, Dalorine, for all you've done. As a hospital, definitely, we must immortalize OO Adekwueku. And so we'll get a committee on that will advise us on the best way to immortalize him. Other too much for him, for all he did for us, for all the roles he played here. More importantly, for also putting us there on the global map. Once again, I want to welcome us to the event. I want to encourage us also to endeavor to participate in subsequent events. Ekwerenne Ekwezika, Chukwu Nonyela in today's event. Dubai is a week-long event, so I've got to be with us so that any night can go off ma. I don't know Jesus Christ anymore.
Let's appreciate the CM deeply. Ochina Wata, Egade. Let me quickly sum up the protocols before we go to the lecture proper. Once again, let me recognize the chairman of today's event, Professor Geshe Mejeka Minamis. Let's recognize the CMD, Professor J.O. Ubaja, Ochina Wata, Ndi Owanine. Now let me recognize the guest lecturer once again, Professor P.I.S. Okafo, Ichi Eburuburu, Babando Wanine. Let me recognize the Provost of the College of Health Sciences, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Professor G.O. Diwe. Let me recognize the representative of the West African College of Surgeons, Professor A.M.E. Wofo. Let me recognize the Accountant General of Anambra State as a whole, who was a former Director of Finance here in Nnamdi Azikiwe University General Hospital, Chief Chudi Okoli. Agwa mi anoga na mamu bondo. Maka na odigo kwa, odigo li ama. Ina odigo li ama. Kwa kwa si eme? Ejwe uku. O wande guo keko. Beme iba izu. O malo na, you know. Ebo eje jog. Eke na yi keni fe na emel gife. Then I recognize Mr. and Mrs. Obiora Mbono. Obiora. Okechukwu Mbono. Obiora. Only represent OO in body and flesh here. Yeah. Obi, you're welcome. And our own CMAC, Okuloka, Okuloka Professor Ogo Ezejiofo, the gentle giant. Now, we have colleagues who are joining us virtually, and they are all watching keenly. And let's recognize and thank our colleagues who are on the virtual platform with us. Let me recognize as much as possible the few of them that I can grasp. Professor Akanimo Esiet, Professor of Urology, University of Calabar, they are all colleagues of Professor Ombono. Professor Clement Osime, Professor of Surgery, University of Benin, is the professor who is the son of a professor. Dr. Harry Oranezi, former member of House of Representatives, and we know him as a former resident in Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital. He was a former secretary of our ARD too, when men were still men. Professor King David, former president of Professor Kelechi Okonta, Professor of Cardiothoracic Surgery, University of Port Harcourt. Let's appreciate him. Mrs. Chinyel Wofo, even a former director of admin of NAUT. Can I be Chinyel on a virtual platform? And a back, you know, Kuyae. He does in Malaka. Let us recognize. Okay. Mrs. Lady, Mrs. Oh, Lady Adonyeili, former Director of Nursing Services of Nahut. Professor Comfort Akujobi, former Provost of Alexei Kweme University. Ndufu Alike, Ebonyi State, Provost of the College of Medicine. Come, he is online with us. Professor Harun Aliman, Professor of Urology. Yes, he passed on that Borno rotation while he was there. Dr. Marcel Akukwe, one of our young proteges of the Emeritus Professor Oborn, who equally studied here and did urology as a specialty. Then Professor Ndoma Egba, former CMD, UCTH Calabar, a very powerful man and a prime mover and a sibling of the popular Senator Ndoma Egba. He is online too, joining us. He's a great figure in the West African College of Surgeons. I think Professor SNC Anyanwu is quite close to him. Professor Ken Ozi Ilo, who is the former president of MD Khan, Nigeria, Jos University Teaching Hospital. Professor Roland Osuji, professor of pediatric surgery, Lasut. Professor Sani Aji, professor of urology, and is equally the provost of the Aminu Kano Teaching Hospital, Kano, right now. He's a good friend of ours and a colleague and contemporary. Professor Chima Ihegihu, our own Chima Ihegihu, professor of orthopedic surgery, is online, unavoidably absent physically. Professor Peter B. Olaiton. Professor Olaiton is another major personality in the West African College of Surgeons. And Professor Obiageli Emelomado, our one and only professor of our own community medicine. She's online. What do you call Jego, Canada, or UK? Mojebe Keba and the community medicine, Geneva. How do you call Geneva? Let me recognize Professor Ademola Pupola, professor of urology, my friend, my contemporary at University College Hospital, Ibadan. Then Dr. Chikodi Onwudinjo, consultant general surgeon, UK. I think he was one of our students too. Professor Philman Okoro, professor of pediatric surgery, PTH, Port Harcourt, River State. And in our midst here, I heard that Ngozi Mbanu, daughter of Professor Oumbonu, is our midst. Where is NG? Wow, let's appreciate her. She's an author, especially in pediatric books. She's the one there. Even if she's not the one we foist it on, you're welcome. We appreciate your presence in our midst. Yes, she's always been around here as a little girl. Yes, the daddy used to bring her along to walk and then the rest of them. And we still have a few people here. Let's just do a quick run over. Dr. Obiesie Sani Abacha, who is going to read the citation of the lecturer. Dr. Ifeato Orangosi is in our midst. Dr. Nkire Zama, also here. Professor M.J. Immortal Anwanwankwo. He's the Dean of Faculty of Health Science and Technology. Let's appreciate him. Dean, you're welcome. He passed through 002. Dr. Judolfo Ugwu is the sub-dean of the Faculty of Medicine. And as the names come up, and then we have a very important personality who I keep skipping over. But do pardon me, as soon as we get her name, we'll bring her into recognition. So on that note, let me call. I heard that Professor Zan Olwe is here. A senior. Wadi brother, Pax Christi. Then I hear Professor Bono's sisters are here. This is their event. No matter how pressed we are for time, they must be recognized and given the due honor which is due to them. And they gave me a beautiful, very brief list here. I thought it would be much longer than this. And I gave them my admission to university in Bwa. The governor has seen it. ATET leave exercise book. They are in their admission. So, Biko, let us recognize them properly. Mrs. Rose Agulwe, who is the sister? Wow. Now, I can't wap now. Kwanaka. If I go see you, hey! It was Amosu. I can never guess. I will call Mrs. Kate O'Coley. The sister too. Let's appreciate her. Kathy. And let us recognize equally Mrs. Mma Adeniji, his sister too. If you know the Kopulobu, you know, and close to Ezra Musu is his son. Let's appreciate his son, who is one of us. Where is Dr. Ekwogu? Shebi is Ekwogu, that's your friend. He would have identified you. So on that note, Chairman, members of the High Table, our CMD, the organizing committee chairman, and my colleagues in the organizing committee, they work silently behind the scene, but I know you know you're duly recognized. Let me call on Sani Abacha, Dr. Sani. Obiesie, to come and read the citation of the inaugural lecturer.
Thank you so much, the MC, the Chairman of Education, the CMD, the Mbonos family, Ezra Musu, all protocols duly observed. May I humbly request our guest lecturer, our own teacher and mentor, to stand up for his brief citation, given the type of event we are having today.
Clear line. Professor P.I.S. Okafor, Professor of Surgery now, hails from Umuchi Village in Ekulobia, in Agwata local government area of Anambra State. He went to St. Patrick's Primary School at Asaba Delta State, then to Calic Modern School at Asaba in Delta State too. Thereafter, Professor proceeded to the famous Okongu Memorial Grammar School, where he was a senior prefect. Then he went to King's College, Lagos, where he also held the position of a school prefect. Please, a round of applause. Professor P.I.S. Okafor studied medicine and surgery at Rostov State Medical Institute of the Russian Federal Republic, former USSR, where he bagged the Doctor of Medicine with honors. He did his housemanship at the University of Nigerian Teaching Hospital, Enugu, did the National Youth Service in Edo State. He did his residency training in UNTH in June 1978. Then he proceeded to Western General Hospital, the famous place Professor Mbono calls Edinburgh. Edinburgh University, Scotland, UK, in September 1982. He also studied at the Institute of Urology, Shaftesbury, London, UK in 1983. He bagged the fellowship of the Medical College of Surgeons in 1985. Then he had the fellowship of the West African College of Surgeons, International College of Surgeons, and of course, International Society of Surgeons. Professor P.I.S. Okafor was a consultant surgeon and assistant medical director at the Royal Hospital, Enugu, before he became a consultant surgeon at the Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital, Nnewi. He became a lecturer at Naut in August 1996, became a senior lecturer in 1999, a reader in surgery in 2003, then a professor of surgery and of course urology in 2005. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor P.I.S. Okafor has retired but very, very active as the chief medical director of St. Victoria Specialist Hospital, Ekulobia. He's one of the safest hands in the field of urology today. Safest hands in the field of urology today. And has continued to mentor so many. He's among the few that operated on same table and in real time with the Grand Commander of Urology, Emeritus Professor O.O. Mbonu, and widely regarded as his first son in urology. Hope I'm in order. No wonder the prostate respects him. There's no way you can operate with Mbonu at real time and the prostate will not respect you. No wonder the kidneys, ureters, bladder, and urethra listen to him. P.I.S. Okafor enucleates any prostate despite the shape, dimensions, and orientation in 130 to 40 seconds and secures hemostasis in less than dimension time. That's a mystery of fate. Any day you operate with him, you must learn a new maneuver in surgery, be it general surgery or urology. He's just tremendously skilled and overwhelmingly blessed by God. You know what I mean? The history of the pistol pack is incomplete without him. The famous hemostatic maneuver saving many after open transvesical prostatectomy. A round of applause for that discovery. In Imo State, where I come from, if you hear someone is sick and has been taken to a club, we already know he has preceding history of loot. He's a member of many learned societies, Nigerian Association of Urological Surgeons, Pan-African Urological Society Association, International Society of Surgeons, and of course, International College of Surgeons. He has been a resource person at many postgraduate review courses of West African College of Surgeons, and of course, the National Postgraduate Medical College, as well as many workshops and scientific presentations. Professor P.S. Okafor supervised postgraduate dissertations of many foremost surgeons that supervise the trainees of the younger ones today. That will tell you when he supervised the dissertations. Professor P.S. Okafor was an examiner to many medical schools, UNIJOS, Ibadan University, just to mention but a few. He served as academic advisor to many students of NAU, and was a hall master when College of Health Sciences had a hotel at Newich. He has contributed so much to the growth of NAU and NAUT. He was a member of the Educational Ventures Committee of Nnamdi Azikiwe University, member of the Libraries Educational Development Committee. He was a member of the Committee in Charge of Students' Accommodation and Advisory Board, that's the SAB. And of course, he has led the Committee of Combined Faculty Lectures here. He was a representative of NAUT, the NAUT board, and of course, a member of the NAUT board of management before retirement. He was a former chairman of the Provost Senior Staff Disciplinary Committee. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor P.S. Okafor served as the head of the Department of Surgery, NAUT and NAUT, between 2002 and 2005, first and second tenures. He led many accreditation teams of both the National and West African College of Surgeons. He has so many articles in many indexed local and international journals and presented so many conference papers at both local and international scenes. He has so many professional distinction awards. Had a merit award in medical excellence by the University of Nigeria Alumni Oka Branch in 2001. In 2003, he had a professional through vocational service award by the Rotary of Oko Polytechnic. He received the Professional Merit Award by the Old Agbata Union in 2010. And he has an outstanding service from the College of Health Sciences, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, in 2010. Of course, the Department of Chemical Pathology also recognized him with an Excellence Award in 2010, too. Professor P.S. Okafor is very, very fit because of his contributions while in the school. It would be nice to recognize that he was a member of the Okongwu Memorial Grammar School Football First 11. That's why we say he's still fit and we continue to be fit. He was a member of the Okongwu Memorial Grammar School Linary Athletics Team and, of course, the member of the Adama Group. He was a school prefect in the King's College Lagos and, of course, a member of the King's College Lagos Football First 11, where he won full college colors for football. A round of applause. He was a member of the King's College Lagos Athletics Team, won the Victor Ludorum Prize. He set a new college record in 110 yards hurdles, representing Nigeria in a triangular college football and athletics competition between Nigeria and the Republic of Benin and Ghana, which held at Achimota High School, Accra, Ghana. He was a member of the King's College Drama Group and, of course, won the Best Actor Prize. He was the secretary of the Nigerian Students Union in Rostov, USSR. Represented Nigerian students in a speech contest among all students in Rostov. Won a cup for the best orator. A round of applause. Professor Okafor did not end there. He won a prize for best all-round foreign student of the Rostov State Medical Institute in the United Soviet Union. Down here, he was the former chairman of the Hospital Management Committee of the General Hospital Club in Agbata Local Government, member Continuing Education Committee, Nigerian Medical Association, Agbata Zone, member of the Ekulobia People's Assembly, Akuru Ono. He was a member of the Enugu Sports Club, T-Date. He was awarded a certificate of contribution to the society, by which Development Union Ekulobia. Everything about Professor Okafor is all about philanthropism.
Thank you so much for all you do, Prof. He was the medical director of the Ancient and Noble Order of the Knights of 509 Ekulobia. He has received awards for his contribution to the St. Joseph Catholic Parish Ekulobia on his Golden Jubilee celebrations. He was a member of the advisory committee to the Igwe Ekulobia Agwata local government. He's an Ichie in the Igwe's cabinet Ekulobia. And of course, he was a member of the Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital Board Management before retirement. His hobbies, playing lawn tennis, watching all types of sports, listening to jazz, evergreen songs, and Christian renditions. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor Pierce Okafor is married to the most beautiful and charming Mrs. Okafor Maureen Uzamaka, and they have four great distinguished members to invite to the stage a true son of a true father, the Ichie Buruburu, Kpakpando Ekulobia, the mentor that pays in kilos, one of the few men that the red cap really fits his dressings any day, anywhere. You can appreciate him and understand what I mean. He's the only man that walks with a beautiful swag while his father walks with a spring. The erudite scholar and the extremely skilled surgeon, Professor Pius Ifeanyi Sunday Okafor.
Kapabando na aputa. I recognize the presence of Professor R. O. Ofieli, immediate past CMD and Professor of Orthopedic Surgery in AMIS.
Thank you. Before we do anything, ladies and gentlemen, I pledge your indulgence to stand up for 1 minute in honor of Professor Mbon. Ebo masirigi noga diranyo tua. Ebo masirigi, oh, ebo masirigi, ebo masirigi, no gadira nyutua, ebo masirigi, narekene. Thank you very much. You may sit down, please. The chairman of this occasion, sir, Wanna, my CMD. In fact, let me stand on exist protocols. Okay, Chukwu Obiora Mbono, MBBS, London, FRCS, Edinburgh, FRCS, Canada. Fellow, West African College of Surgeons, Fellow, International College of Surgeons, and Fellow, International Society of Surgeons, O.O., as his contemporaries called him, Nwazularu, as his parents fondly called him, Nnanyelugo, as members of his kindred fondly called him, Chinemeze Oka, a chieftaincy title bestowed on him by His Royal Highness Igwe Gibson Nwosu Ezozuoka. I was present at that ceremony. Ozo Rando Mbaukwu, a chieftaincy title conferred on him by his bosom and inseparable friend, His Royal Highness Igwe Mbaukwu Ezamosu. ladies and gentlemen, to give a lecture on the life and times of this Iroko with such intimidating credentials is definitely an onerous task. It was 7 p.m. on the 23rd of January 2024. The CMAC of Nayut, Professor Ogochukwu Ezejiofor, he called me to tell me that I have been unanimously selected by the management of Nayut to give a lecture on our father, Professor Mbonu. My first reaction was trepidation plus palpitation. However, for me, it was a great honor. But I was wondering, how can I, of all his contemporaries scattered all over the world, of all his numerous professional products and friends, of all his colleagues, how can I be the one to read a lecture on this, our professional father? Well, on deeper reflection, it was very, very clear to me that I should, like one of our politicians during the campaign, declare myself Emi Loko. Yes, Emi Loko, and I claim it. And there are reasons for that. And here I am, fulfilling that role. Why should it be me? Well, to answer that question, I can give you true genealogy of my relationship with Professor Mbonu. I think that minus his wife and his immediate relations, I probably had the longest unbroken interwoven relationship and association with Professor Mbonu. My first, thank you. I never knew him from Adams, but my first contact with him was in 1977. I had just finished my youth service in then Bender State, got employed at UBTH as a resident doctor. However, after 1 month there, I became very homesick, and the urge to be nearer my home is to UNTH Enugu for residency position. Lo and behold, when I came to the interview, I knew every other person there minus then Dr. Mbonu. And incidentally, all the questions thrown at me on that day were by this then Dr. Mbonu. But judging by his body language, his facial expressions, and the way he was nodding, it was clear to me at that point that our chemistry matched. Suffice it to say that I passed the interview and among the young doctors selected into the pioneer set of residency training at UNTH. And I believe that Dr. Mbonu was instrumental to my selection. So that is the way we started our life. During my sojourn at UNTH from 1977 to 1985, I trained and worked under many consultants, the good, the bad, and the ugly. But well, most of them were good. I remember Professor Udeku. I remember Professor Joe Ojukwu, Professor Fidelis Ude, Professor Nwako, Professor Nene Obianyo, etc., etc. I must mention your uncle, Professor Humphrey Anyanwu, before you deal with me. However, I spent most years under Professor Mbonu, and he trained, nurtured, guided me to pass the primary and part one fellowship in one sitting of the Nigerian Postgraduate Medical College. That was in 1980. As was the practice then, residents with part one were expected to travel overseas to a reputable university for further training. It was this same Dr. Mbonu that secured positions for me in three universities. University of Orawa, as he pronounced it, in Canada. University of Edinburgh, Scotland, UK, and University of Glasgow, also in UK. Professor Mbonu actually had preferred for me to train in the same university where he trained in Canada. However, delays in documentations and visa applications were taking a long time. So we settled for Edinburgh, that came faster. In 1982, I traveled to the UK and started a specialist urology training under Professor Chisholm of the prestigious West General Hospital, Edinburgh. Professor Chisholm was a personal friend of Dr. Mbonu then, hence the very wonderful exposure and training given to me there. When I came back to Nigeria in 1983, Professor Mbonu also sent Dr. J. Orakwe, now Professor Orakwe, to the same hospital under the same Professor Chisholm for training. He would have sent more if that practice had continued. Back to UNTH in 1983, I was posted again to Professor Mbonu's unit as his senior registrar. Let me tell you, if you worked under Professor Mbonu, there was no master-servant relationship. It was a family. Professor Mbonu cared very deeply about those working under him. And I can remember that we used to go to sports club with him to share a bottle of beer after a tedious day's job. He treated us beautifully. He went beyond that. At some point in time, late Professor Aloy Agaj came back from UK and joined his unit with me. Those who know Aloy Agaj is a no-nonsense man. And people were wondering whether we could get on together. But once you're under Professor Mbonu, the spirit of Mbonu will get into you, whether you liked it or not. So suffice it to say that we worked so beautifully that when Aloy Agaj wedded, Professor Mbonu was the chairman of the occasion and I was the MC of the occasion. Not only that, James, the first son, is my godson. In October 1985, I passed the Part 2 fellowship examination, thanks to further tutelage and guidance of Professor Mbonu, thus becoming the first indigenous professional product of this great urologist. Others were to follow in sequence: Professor Jesse Orakwe, Professor Zanda Nwofor here, etc., 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 because we were being trained out and others were getting their training from us. In 1986, when I left, employed by the famous Royal Hospital Enugu as their consultant surgeon urologist. But my relationship with Professor Mbonu continued as he referred all his special patients who needed his private attention to me for our joint management. Between me and Professor Mbonu, I can tell you that we were operating on the cream de la cream of the society. We operated on traditional rulers, clergymen, parliamentarians, even a speaker of House of Assembly, etc., etc., etc. That shows you the crop of people that respected him. In 1990, when I established my own hospital, St. Victoria Specialty Hospital and Maternity in my hometown, Ekwulabia, coincidentally, Professor Mbonu also relocated to Nayut. Our fate was tied together, and our joint management of patients continued. He would come to Ekwulabia over the weekend. We operated on people together. Is Dr. Izuar around? He used to be a permanent feature in our operations at Ekwulabia with Professor Mbonu. In 1992, Professor Mbonu talked me into returning to academics, and he arranged my interview in his office at Nnewi. Dr. Obiekwe, who was then the HOD of surgery, Dr. Anyang was sitting here, and Dr. Ofieli, doctors then, were members of the panel. Suffice it to say that that interview was just a formality. This is how Professor Mbonu brought me into NIUT as a consultant surgeon stroke urologist, and later lecturer one at NEWI. Our relationship even then became much, much more cemented, and this led to close cooperation between him, myself, Dr. Arakwe here seated, and Dr. Chianakwana then here seated. The result of that cooperation ended with all of us becoming professors in our different fields. So, it was the above exposure that offered me the opportunity to have a holistic knowledge about the life and times of Professor Mbonu. However, today, I can only nibble at the surface of my knowledge of him. I can only, so to say, palpate the tip of the iceberg. You are all conversant, I believe, with what Mark Antony said at the burial of Julius Caesar. I have come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do, live after them. So let it be with Caesar. Today, however, I have come to kickstart the burial obsequies of Professor O.O. Mbonu, and most importantly, to praise him, because his many good deeds will follow him from today to eternity. So, ladies and gentlemen, let the bells of joy continue to ring in his honor from now to eternity. Let me lead you through some important landmarks in the early stages of Professor O.O. Mbonu's life. He was born on the 4th of January, 1939, as the first son of Chief Bernard Oyane Mbonu and Madame Florence Mbonu of Umudioka, Oka, then the capital town of Oka Division in Onitsha Province of Eastern Nigeria. His father was a civil servant, supervisor of prisons, and that meant they were always on the move throughout the country. And young Okechukwu, of course, followed them from town to town. That notwithstanding, young Okechukwu finished his primary school education and passed the FSLC examinations with distinction. From there, he went on to do his high school at Oguta, and he passed his WASC examinations in grade one. He then gained direct admission into the prestigious University of Ibadan, stroke UCH. At that point in time, UI was an affiliate of University of London. So if you read there or studied there, you went home very quickly with degree from London University. In 1965, he graduated from the medical school with MBBS honors, distinguishing in surgery, as expected. His contemporaries at UCH, including my wife's late uncle, Dr. Walter Madike, and our lady here, Mommy Ebuonu, even though 3 years below Professor Mbonu, was there also. They all talked positively about Professor Mbonu. They all poured encomiums on his academic excellence and positive extramural activities. Yes, I underline positive. And I do remember that he represented Nigeria in many competitions in table tennis. That shows you how versatile Okey Mbonu was. In 1966, while doing his rotating housemanship at UCH, the political climate in Nigeria exploded, and it was to your tents, O Israel. Those who know the history of Nigeria, it started with Obafemi Awolowo being charged with treasonable felony and thrown into prison. And then the harakiri in Western region between S.L. Akintola and Adebenro, and the election which Adebenro won was rigged away from him. And then Western Nigeria went into riots, Operation Wait Here, etc., etc. There was no order, no law, nothing. And this ended with a coup by some majors in the Nigerian Army in January, 6th of January, 1966. May 29th, the same year, there was a counter coup and the pogrom against Eastern Region inhabitants elsewhere started. This necessitated that Mbonu and other doctors at UCH had to scuttle home to Eastern Region. When he came back to the East, he enlisted into the Biafran Army as an army doctor, and he was posted to Emekuku Hospital. Ladies and gentlemen, every bad thing, every bad situation may have a flip side. In spite of the bombs falling right, left, and center, in spite of the bloodshed everywhere, in spite of broken bones and people, mass casualty, being rushed into the hospital, young Oke Mbonu was still able to watch and notice the wriggling wastes of nurses in the hospital. And definitely, he noticed an awesomely, ravishingly beautiful damsel from Onitsha, a nurse by profession, and her name, Veronica Chukwura. He got entangled to this nurse, and these two went on to tie the knot as husband and wife, a union that blossomed till death snatched daddy, as Vero fondly called Professor Mbonu, on the morning of 14th November 2023. In 1970, after the war, Dr. Mbonu moved to Liverpool on a Commonwealth scholarship to specialize in surgery. Later on, his wife Vero joined him. Because of the massive experience he gathered during the war, it took him just about 2 years. In 1973, Dr. Mbonu collected his fellowship of the Royal College of Edinburgh. In 1973, husband and wife relocated to the University of Ottawa, Canada, for a specialist training in urology. In 1975, he obtained both the FRCS Canada and the specialist certificate in urology from the Royal College of Surgery of Canada. His first child, Ngozi Chukwuka, here seated, was born in Canada. And that is why she's a Canadian citizen and still lives in Canada. My plea, Ngozi, my dear, please, when the dust has settled, when everything is done about our daddy, kindly take mommy to Canada so that she can rest there for some time. That's my plea to you. In Canada, Dr. Mbonu was an exemplary student and then surgeon. They referred cases to him that was beyond their comprehension. His surgical skill manifested on a very high level. So, he was offered automatic employment to work in the same hospital where he trained. But the urge to go back to Nigeria and his relations outweighed the comfort and the beauty of organized life in Canada. So in 1976, Dr. Mbonu packed his bags and baggage, collected his certificates, and headed back to Nigeria with his family to settle down in Enugu, where he got employed as a consultant urologist surgeon at UNTH Enugu, and also a senior lecturer in the Faculty of Medicine, UNEC, Enugu. That is how the Mbonu that we all know today germinated and blossomed into the Iroko tree with numerous branches and leaves that became a shade for many birds and foothold for many young men and women to fly high, including me. At this point, if you can shift it up a bit, let me share my field of vision about Professor Mbonu. Mbonu was an excellent medical doctor. He epitomized the doctor of Hippocrates' vision in words and deeds. He was exquisitely grounded in the art and science of medicine and surgery. He was very thorough, very painstaking in his management of his patients. His surgical expertise was phenomenal, using his sound background of topographic anatomy and operative surgery to achieve maximal positive results. I begged Abi Nisho that I would not like to be interrupted with time factor. So please. Water. Okay. Yes, yeah, all right. Elders are usually advised not to drink water from the bottle. As you grow old, the swallowing reflex degenerates. If you don't take time, you'll be choked. So that's why I had to drink from that glass. I'm okay. Professor Mbonu quickly accumulated a large population of patients who sought his help both at UNTH and beyond. Dr. Mbonu became a visiting surgeon to many, many hospitals in Enugu. I can remember St. Hilda's Hospital. I can remember Onyemelukwe's Hospital. I can remember Okafor Memorial Hospital. I can remember Royal Hospital. I can remember St. Martin's Hospital, etc., etc., etc. And of course, he tagged me along in all those places and they exposed me to the real-time surgery and the maneuvers therein. At UNTH, Dr. Mbonu changed the practice of urology and attracted colleagues from other countries to Enugu to operate with him. Before he came back to Enugu, urology was practiced by general surgeons with special interest in urology. Professor Fidelis Ude, if you remember, and then Professor Ray Anikwe. But when Professor Mbonu landed, urology changed. Hitherto, approaches to the kidney for operation was transperitoneal. You had to deal with intestine, etc. And Mbonu introduced extraperitoneal approach to the kidney by a subcostal incision. That became the norm at NIUT, at UNTH in those days. Professor Mbonu, if you remember, was the first endoscopic surgeon to appear on our climb. He came home from Canada with his own ureteroscope and cystoscope, etc., etc., and started doing transurethral resection of the prostate. And those days, I can assure you, it was a very difficult venture. It is not like today, when camera is there and everything is very readily made. So he started it. Those of us who trained at UNTH, we remember when Professor Kwote came from Ghana on Dr. Mbonu's invitation. Dr. Kwote was an expert worldwide known for his method of ureteroplasty using a flap from the scrotal skin, pedicled flap. The theater that day was filled to the brim with students and doctors and even consultants alike watching the wonderful music played by Professor Kwote. That was thanks to Dr. Mbonu. What about Mbonu as a teacher? Mbonu had very peculiar teaching skills. He ignited personal relationship with students and goes extra length to help them with extra tutorials. If you visited the If you came to the lecture hall when Mbonu is lecturing, it is jam-packed with students who are keen to watch. We are all witnesses to that. And he taught and lectured in a way that you, the student, will understand why it is important to do anatomy, biochemistry, physiology before you move on to other sciences in medicine. He tied up everything and you discover that medicine was a continuum up till even our own stage. Dr. Mbonu in the clinics, when he's running a clinic, you will not have any chance because people are all over the place. Is it in the theater? There he plays music and teaches as he operated. What of Mbono as an examiner? Dr. Mbono, Professor Mbono, was a very humane examiner. If you failed an examination under him, then you are not redeemable. Professor Mbono will reassure you when you come before him. He will pat you on the back and advise you not to fidget and tell you that we are not going to kill you. All we want is for you to prove why you should not pass. And many passed under him. And anybody who failed, failed on his own. It was that humane. What about administration? This is where Professor Mbono made his mark. He was a very excellent administrator in anything you gave him to handle. I remember that when he came back, 1976, he was immediately appointed the coordinator of the Department of Surgery. Those who were there at that time knew that before he came, the surgery department was disorganized. But Professor Mbono organized very, very well. Then in 1980 at UNTH, he was appointed the director of postgraduate training. Suffice it to say that before he came, training in residency at UNTH was completely disorganized. And many of my colleagues who started out with me left Enugu and went to UK to do their fellowship there, which was very fast. But by the time Professor Mbono finished organizing the training session, you could see pass marks coming from everywhere in the Nigerian fellowship. In 1986, Professor Mbono, still a doctor then, was appointed the CMAC of UNTH. If you remember, those were the days of Idi Abo and this our Buhari, everlasting Buhari. Those were the years of the first Jakpa syndrome. Most of his colleagues left Nigeria. I remember Ray Anikwe, he left. Tim Mwabunike left. Dr. Amene, respiratory physician, left. Dr. Okechukwu, anesthetist, left. Etc., etc. Even our own Beatrice Ume left. But did Mbono leave? He stayed put and reorganized teaching hospital to the best of his ability. It was no wonder then that he was appointed under the prodding of Professor Nwankwo, who was then the Vice Chancellor of NIU, and Professor Robinson, Rob Eguatu. They recommended him to the federal government and he was appointed as the CMD of NIUT, I think it was in 1990. We will not be doing those who served before him a good service if we don't say that they laid a good foundation for him. I think the first provost stroke CMD was Professor Umera. After Umera, it was Professor Ezilo. Then after Ezilo, Mbono came. The difference is that those other people were in charge of Asutech Teaching Hospital. But by the time Mbono came in, this teaching hospital was converted to a federal institution, and therefore it will not be wrong to call him a pioneer CMD of NIUT. You are all members of this facility. It will be understating the obvious that Professor Mbono was an astute administrator. He was that good that he made no enemies. There was harmony between all members of staff of teaching hospital. There was no, what do you call the new, some associations that came up. You said it, I didn't say. He was that good. And he had an open door policy. And anybody could come into his office. And Professor Mbono, if he refuses whatever you plead of him, by the time you leave his office, you'll be convinced that actually he needed to refuse. Otherwise, he was very approachable. He was so good as the CMD of this institution that when he came in, the infrastructure here changed. And General Hospital Mburi, that's what they used to call here, it changed and became a real teaching hospital. Structures were coming up. He attracted rich men all over the place to come here and take up some business. So you all know how good Mbon was as the CMD of this institution. He laid a very good foundation for those who were coming after him. And I remember that at the end of his tenure, Igworis of Nnewi, in addition to some rich men in Nnewi, went to Abuja to plead that they return Professor Mbon for more tenure. But of course, Professor Mbon, being the man he is, he refused. He said, please, I'm done. There are younger men coming after me. And therefore, after him, there was a short interregnum when an ectopic consultant was drafted into teaching hospital. He tried his best. Yeah, he tried his best under the circumstances of those days. But soon after him, the baton was handed over to Professor Fieli. And Professor Fieli, we must all continue to remember him. Professor Fieli was good. Professor Fieli raised the bar of management in this place. Professor Fieli opened the floodgates for employment. No wonder he still walks majestically amongst the citizens of this facility. Then, of course, after Professor Ofieli, still based on the good foundation, which they all laid, Professor Igwebe took over. Amiable CMD. Very cool-headed. Smiling all the time. In spite of the fact that he's married to a lawyer. Who puts it to him every day? He was still able to guide this institution into the very beautiful hands of our Chinnamata. I don't want to praise him here because he's present, but just rest assured that we are all happy. This is no longer the UNTH that we know. A lot of things have happened. And I hear that very soon you will all move to the new site. Thanks to this man. Innovations galore. Every faculty, every department, everybody's happy. I had the pathologist shouting that their department has changed. And they're even planning to do further things in pathology department. Same elsewhere. Thank you, sir, for keeping the... Right. All these positions which Mbon occupied did not stop him from pursuing academics. He was an active member of the West African College of Surgeons, and he rose on the ranks until he became the president of West African College of Surgeons. During his tenure, Nnewi was brought out to the world. Most of us who were not interested in conferences and seminars, we traversed the west coast of Africa, going from country to country on conferences along with Professor Mbon. It was he who opened floodgates for appointment of examiners for those colleges. We can never forget him. He did very well. And I think Zander Mwofo is going in his footsteps, and we hope he will get there. You are already in charge of the Nigerian sector. Yes. And even the International College of Surgeons. What about Professor Mbon as a Christian? All Professor Mbon did, it was always God first being his watchword. Professor Mbon lived a very, very simple life. He was not attracted by the locker of gold and wealth. Professor Mbon, that I know, many years, even from UNTH to Nayut, had only a Peugeot 504, a white one. And when he looked to him, like people were overtaking him by new cars, including us, who even bought Mercedes-Benz. Professor Mbon, all he did was to change the color of his 504. Am I right? He changed it to red and continued driving it. Professor Mbono that I know, in spite of all the positions he held, in spite of all the naira that he touched, he never accumulated wealth anywhere. He lived in Newi as CMD for many years, and when he retired, he rented a flat. He had no home of his own at Newi. The only property I know Professor Mbono has is at Enugu, and it was a gift from the governor, erstwhile governor Ebano, what's his name again? Chimaroke. He gave him that plot of land free of charge. Until death, Professor Mbono has not finished developing it. That is the type of character he is. Was not interested in money. Simple. A Christian. Professor Mbono was so simple that there was no difference to him whether you are big or small, whether you're a cleaner, driver. We were all equal before him. You would see him standing out there greeting everybody. He knew everybody that came across him with first name. And if you discuss anything with him today, tomorrow he will ask you again about your discussion. It was that simple-minded. We can go on and on and on about Mbono as a Christian. Those of you at Naiut, you know how active he was in the Anglican Communion here. Was a permanent feature every Sunday here. So it's not surprising that the Anglican Communion made him a knight of St. Christopher. That is the pinnacle of Christian faith. What about Mbono as a family man? He was a superlative family man. He had a perfect relationship with his wife, and the wife trusted him absolutely. I remember an occasion. When Vero, we tickled her and we told her, your husband is very, very handsome and is very, very liked by everybody. Don't you think women are running after him? And Vero said, that's their headache. And then we asked her along the line, what if, perchance, you come to Professor Mbono's office and you see him on top of another woman? Do you know what Vero said? Said, if that happened, then it must be a new clinical method of examination of fetus. That was the extent of trust between husband and wife. Those of you who know them will agree with me that Vero was his handbag and his laptop. Unlike some of us who go on conferences with ectopic laptops. Professor Mbono had very beautiful children, and he devoted his life to training his children properly, putting in them the same virtues that he shared. And today he has beautiful children who are up and coming. If there was any challenge amongst his children, Professor Mbono did everything he could to change the tide. And today he's a multiple grandfather. We thank God for him. His family attachment did not end with his children. He looked after all members of his kindred. I remember when he was living in the staff quarters of UNEC. At a point in time, there were 13 members of his kindred living in his house, being fed by him, was paying their school fees, and made sure he carried all of them along. Junior, am I right? I'm right. So you can see the type of man he is. Many times when I went for shopping at Robin stores, and he was always there buying things and doing shopping for his wife and children. What a man he was as a family man. What about Mbono as a social animal? At UNTH, when he was still a young man, it was Professor Mbono that fulfilled all these functions that Professor Emejulu is fulfilling today, and Sani Abacha. He was always anchoring all social events. Professor Mbono valued friendship, and he will bend over backwards to help his friends. I hope you still remember Dr. T.O.K. Usuafo. Late. We call him Ijele Nayut. When Ijele Nayut died, Professor Mbono mobilized everybody in this teaching hospital. And it was Mbono really who conducted his burial ceremony. And he did not stop at that. He helped T.O.K.'s wife to get into Nayut, into UNISIC as a lecturer. And she finished there and retired as a professor. He did not stop there. He helped to train T.O.K.'s children who were medical students. And even went on to find a position in house job for his daughter. So that you can see how much Mbono can go to help a friend. You may remember Dr. Chika Akvinle, late bosom friend of Professor Mbono. They were so close. They did things together. They did things together. And Mbono would have accompanied Dr. Chika Akvinle on that fateful journey of that fateful day. But for some reason, that morning something happened and our Mbono did not travel with Chika Akvinle. And you know how it all ended. Professor Mbono showed high mark of friendship when Chika Akvinle died. He made sure that the corpse was quickly taken to the mortuary, made sure that he was sutured up so that he again looked like a human being because his brain was shattered. You couldn't recognize Chika Akvinle. At his burial, Professor Mbono featured very prominently. There is a young man in our midst. I think I saw him. Jackson Grant. I think you're here. He is one of those Dr. Mbono brought up, made a son, and made him what he is. When this young man finished his training in medical lab science, he couldn't find a job. Professor Mbono looked all over the country, gave him letters, and eventually they found him a job at Aminu Kano Teaching Hospital. But we were not satisfied. So he told him, as long as I am here, I will make sure something happens for him. And that is how Grant Jackson became an employee of this hospital. And today, ladies and gentlemen, I hear he's chief of staff to the CMD. That is thanks to Professor Mbono. Ladies and gentlemen, there is one other thing Professor Mbono did, without naming names. There was a lecturer amongst us who was nearly dismissed from UNISIC with some bogus charges of plagiarism. Professor Mbono was in the committee set up to try the young man. And he made sure all those accusations were quashed. And he saved that young lecturer. And behold, today, that lecturer is a gem in the medical profession. Without naming names, this young man has become a name in Nigeria that you cannot mention 10 who is who in the medical practice without mentioning him. We would have lost him to the society. And I can swear, or even think, that somewhere along the line, this young man will become a vice chancellor of some university. Yeah. Permit me to touch some lessons that I learned from the life and times of Professor Mbonu. There is a Latin adage which says, Vita mutato, non tollito, which translates that life forms do not decay, they only mutate or change from one form to another. Professor Mbonu is not dead. I emphasize it, he is not dead. Good people do not die. They only transit from one level to another. Professor Mbonu still exists in his children. He still exists in his numerous students and mentees, in his colleagues, and all those whose life he touched one way or another. For example, you can look at how his colleagues and friends responded to a call by the committee raised, chaired by Professor Nwofor and the HOD of surgery. That blog got at least, as of today, 200 responses, all of them gathering money. Name it, I will not name the amount for the sake of armed robbers. But that shows you that this is a man who cannot die because he's remembered every day by his colleagues. There's a quotation from Shakespeare, one of his works. Life is a stage. A poor player struts and frets his hours upon the stage and then is heard no more. Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. But Professor Mbonu has proven that life well lived can signify something. For even though his stage curtains have been drawn, the ovation for the part he played in it is still loud and will reverberate eternally. Professor Mbonu, in his simplicity, will always insist that whereas we must strive for excellence in whatever we do, our successes must not degenerate to arrogance and pass margarine, hence the AAA syndrome. He identified certain professionals who are otherwise good, but they're usually arrogant, they're usually pasmagaras. They talk down on their colleagues. Mbonu was never like that. I can't remember any other doctor. That is Mbonu, the AAA syndrome number one. Professor Mbonu also advocates the second AAA syndrome. AAA stands for availability, amiability, and ability. And this applies mainly to medical doctors, particularly those in the private sector. You must make yourself available all the time to your patients, even at night. I think it was Robert Eguatu who told me that he asked Professor Mbonu once, do you ever switch out your phone? Because whenever I call you, even at night, you still answer. And Professor Mbonu said that he doesn't switch off his phone. That is making himself available to his patients. The second A is amiability. You may be a wonderful doctor. You may be knowledgeable. You may be very active. They may know you. But if you are not amiable to your patients, you have lost it. Amiability must be part and parcel of every doctor. That is the way Professor Mbonu sees it. And finally, ability. He emphasized that every doctor must continue to update his knowledge because he says, if you don't update your knowledge in medicine and surgery, you will be downgraded. So he emphasized for us to continue to update. Let me lead you gradually through the last days of Professor O.O. Mbonu's life on earth. Professor Mbonu's demise is a proof that if you lived a good life, your transition is very likely to be seamless and smooth. Professor Mbonu, as far as I know, never had any obvious debilitating illness. Even we would travel with Professor Mbonu from here to Ilorin, if you remember, when we went for a conference. The vehicle may stop once or twice for people to go and urinate. Mbonu will not do it. He will stay put in the car and hold his urine. I never noticed in all my communication with him any sign of loots. If you don't have an illness in the area you specialize in, then you must be something else. He did not have any. Professor Mbonu, that I know, never used glasses. He never used walking stick or ear devices. His mentation was complete and his brain as sharp as razor. He forgot nothing. He remembered everything. Professor Mbonu walked with a spring in his feet and you could hardly guess his real age. His last weeks on earth were very, very active. He was attending conferences. For those of you who came to the NMA conference at Awka this year, he was there on the podium with the rest of us. I chaired the occasion and he was there. And it was he who handed a plaque to Yuma. You remember? Not long after that, he attended the conference of Association of Pathologists of Nigeria and played an active part there. Professor Mbonu attended all the inaugural lectures at UNISIC. That showed you how active his last days were. I chatted with him almost on a daily basis on WhatsApp. And even on the 13th of November 2023, we exchanged greetings with flowers and cups of coffee on WhatsApp. Professor Mbonu's plan for the 14th of November 2023 was to travel to Nibo with his wife on a condolence visit to Professor Zander Nwofor, who lost his sister. That was 14th plan for the next day. On the 13th of November, 2023, he went to bed, slept very coolly, woke up in the morning of 14th of November, 2023. He prayed as usual with his wife and then went down to do some work on his laptop, while his wife went to the kitchen to prepare breakfast. Mommy later came out to see Daddy sitting with his head on the laptop. Mommy called him, but there was no answer. She touched him, but there was no response. Being a nurse, and a good one at that, she checked for signs of life, but there was none. In total disbelief, she phoned Dr. Mberi, am I right? And told him to come and help him interpret this bizarre situation. In total disbelief, Dr. Mberi soon arrived. He was also very confused when he came. And they decided to carry the body of our teacher to a nearby hospital where Professor Mbonu was declared clinically dead. That is how he died. Nunc dimittis. His chapter ended. In conclusion, I like the quotation, Veni, Vidi, Vici. Translates as, I came, I saw, and I conquered. Professor Mbonu came into this world. He saw the world. He traversed the world. He went to all globes of the world. He conquered them. Now he has run his good race. He has paid his dues, and he has seamlessly joined his ancestors. Unlike a whitened sepulcher that is beautiful outside, but contains rotten body, bones, and maggots inside, Professor Mbonu's life was clean, both inside and outside. Our professional father and past CMD of NIOSH. Adieu, Emeritus Professor of Surgery. Adieu, Mwazularu. Adieu, Nanyelugo. Adieu, Chinemeze Awka. Adieu, Ozora Ndumba Okwu. We will never forget him. just like I started this lecture with a short song, I will, in comfort to all of us who have lost him, and in comfort to the relations, allow us to sing, Obim Deredu. Obim Deredu Gyatono Jo. Obim Deredu Gachukwa Magi Fogo. Obim Deredu. Obim Deredu Gyatono Jo.
Obin deredu, obin deredu ya tono jo. Oya mare hamoge merebo. Obin deredu ya tono jo. Obin deredu, chukwa mare hamoge merebo. Obin deredu ya tono jo. Obin deredu, chukwa.
May we give a round of applause to this. Babando. Babando. Ichie buruburu. Ibole ife uneli. All the kankewa kami si obu that he forgets nothing and he remembers everything. Please, let's appreciate Professor Oumba. I'm sure everyone here agrees that Professor Pierre S. Okafor simply took us down memory lane for the past 50 years. And a little more for those who were there during the Biafran Army Medical Corps. Bang, in my hometown. Not in the Google. So everybody should take that along too. So ladies and gentlemen, this has been very refreshing. I don't see any inaugural lecture that could be as encompassing and comprehensive as this. It's intimidating, it's passionate, it's emotional, and it's authoritative. That is, the man who was standing there was talking with just a few prints on the board there. Babando. Yes, when I grow up, I would like to be like you, sir. Let me recognize, before we take some short tributes, the presence of some important personalities here. Dr. Kenneth Okeke is here with us. The head of ENT. Or is somebody choking? Oh, thank you. When PIS talked about old men choking on their drink, I told him not to worry. EAE Afiadigwe is sitting here in the floor. Mrs. Singol Fieli is in our midst. As in Ifenodefa Ekusovia, that's the wife of our immediate past CMD, and my own sister. I take pride in identifying with Ngoa Fieli. Please, let's give a round of applause to her. All these, Rob changed things. Rob changed something. If Ngoa was not there, Rob would not change anything. That is the assurance I'm giving you. So, name mam, Dalorine, oh, Jidekwa Kisie, Jideo, Mebekwa Kisie, Meo, Aposikwana, Anya Siria Gini, no, Melokwa Jebe Kisie, Meo. Watching a man, a canang, a FNAJL Gozi, Dr. Victor Mordekwe, Dr. Victor Mordekwe, who is our MD CAM chairman in Nauth, should be somewhere running up and down. I recognize your presence. I can equally see Dr. Tim Mberi, associate professor of urology, who is there. Yeah. You can't hide. I will find you if you hide, and I will identify you. I don't know. I heard that the NMA president, Dr. Uche Ojimma, is in our midst. Represented by, Jaido, Dr. Jide Onyekwelo, who is the Secretary General of the Nigerian Medical Association. Please, come to the high table, sir. Your seat has always been there. And at this juncture, having stepped on, please, can you make another seat available, please? If it is available, you let me know. So that Professor Rofiel, immediate past CMD, will equally come to the high table, please. Immediate CMD. Jaido, Dalorine, you're welcome. So NMA Nigeria is here. Let me equally recognize. Let's appreciate Professor Rob Ofieli. Watching a Melo. Yes, a sharp guy. That's not sharp. Sharp guy, sharp doctor with sharp children who are all doctors. Now, Abosiano, yes, Katoleanol. So let us equally request with all humility and honor that Professor Anthony Osita Igwegbe should come to the high table. The CMD and Yego order. You know, if not may obey the last order, sir, because kindly come over. This is the husband of the head of service of the entire Anambra State. No bro wata kili kwa. One, I can even amen and I would. Retired director of schools of Anambra State is here. Retired director of schools. Lady Ngozi Egwuatuna, miss. Let's appreciate and recognize her. Mrs. Chinyala Onwuka, who is the head of corporate affairs of Nauth, has been on her feet for the past 3 weeks. I don't know where she is, but let us do one to just appreciate her for all her work. HOD audit, Mrs. Ifi Anoliefo is here. Abona, I recognize the CMD on Ansubu generally. So let's appreciate the head of audit, please. Oh, if I will find out too, can we clap for Ndi now? HOD works, engineer Dr. Pamela. Is she here? Pamela, PhD. Okay, maybe so we are making sure we have power supply. Good public address system too. HOD Nursing Services, Mrs. Ezekwem Agnes. My personal friend and my in-law. Biko, can the ushers, the head of nursing services should come to the high table, please. If I have specific instruction from the chairman, the CMD, and the guest lecturer combined. All Kalelefane disobey. Mrs. Ezekwem should come up to the head of nursing services, Nnamdi Azikiwe University Teaching Hospital. Head of physiotherapy, Mr. Zubiko Obed. Let's appreciate him wherever he is. You can wave. Do something for us. Yes, let's appreciate him. Thank you very much. Head of surgery and combined board of surgery chairman, Dr. C. D. Emegako. I'm not going to be if we're around. Dr. Emegako, on a girl in it, okay, out of a theater, they're ready. Adam, if I'm a and histopathology head of department, Dr. Ezejiofor. Oh, quite the same as Ezejiofor. Ah, that same as Ezejiofor. I take. Then, before we take the tributes, none of which will last more than 3 minutes, so that we'll be out here before 2 p.m. There are a lot of our colleagues on the virtual platform. There are really, really a lot of them. Doctors and professors, Ajibola Hafiz, Akunne, Amina Abubakar, Benjamin Chukuma is Professor Borno's Director of Admin. And all the Kwaka Ogi are working. Let's appreciate him. Dr. Brenda Chibuzo Bala Chidi Ochiaboto Chinyalo Faro, Professor Ngozi Ekeke, one of the proteges and examinees of Professor Ombono, who is powerfully powering on at the University of Port Harcourt Teaching Hospital, is equally online. He sent a message that we're all doing well and he appreciates our work. Chinyalo Faro Chuka Ogunne, another pupil of his, Chukwudimma Okafor. We have Daniel Obuabo, Aniobi John, Kamelo Ezedani, Ifemi Awafo, Dr. Brown, Raymond Okechukwu, Prosper Okonkwo, Onyekwena Udochukwu, Emma Oyibo, Esther Umadi, Ibrahim Fadei, Ngozi Ifezulike, Ikem, Dr. Ikem, Kenneth Keith, Mbakiigwe, Muna Chira, Nicholas, Nnamdi Nwora, Nonson Nebwe, Nahu Dakum, my friend, my colleague, and my co-panel member, Waka Andrew, Wanne, Ifanyo Okoli, Olumide E. Elebute, Omoro Dion Irowa, Origi Sunday, Osilama Obi, Phil Okoro, Samuel Ademola, Stanley Ume, Stephen Garba, Ucha Achebe, Uche Ume, Victor Modekwe, MD Khan is both online and offline. Vincent Ebulwe, Ngwobia, Peter Agu, Nicholas Jamik, Okechukwu Ekunife, Adeze Ngode, and Andrew Dogo, and many others. We welcome and we appreciate your presence on the virtual platform. You give visibility to us and give some honor to all the things we are doing here, and we appreciate you. Even though our hands can't reach you, but our voices and our eyes can see you and appreciate your contributions. On this note, let us take short tributes. Short tributes as directed by the chairman. The day is fast spent. We barely have an hour to 2 o'clock. And we want to plead with those who wish to. I have a name, but I know that outside that, one or two people may still want along the line. If you have to give your tribute, please skip all the protocols. They've been duly and rightly established. Go straight to your tributes for about 2 minutes, tidy up, and then the next tribute will be taken. Or else, I got a lot of questions. And we're all coming together here tomorrow. We are all coming together again tomorrow for the commendation service. So we start with the provost of the College of Health Sciences, Nnamdi Azikiwe University.
Thank you very much, JKC, Chairman, CMD, our guest lecturer. All protocols observed. We all know that Emeritus Professor Oumbono is a giant in the medical field. He was a great teacher and mentor, especially when it concerns clinical training and administration. He touched the life of virtually everybody. He was not wealthy in terms of earthly resources, but even before now, and as testified by one of his mentees, he was rich in children and grandchildren that he mentored through academics, clinical training, and administration. As we mourn his passage, we will not cry too much. Rather, let us celebrate the legacies of the times and memories he's leaving behind. As we begin the processes of the rites of passage of this great icon, let us pray that God will grant us the serenity and peace to have a very successful ceremony. May the soul of Emeritus Professor Oumbono rest in peace. Amen.
I'd like to call on Professor Ifeoma Ebuonu, please, to say something about our departed father and brother and friend.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. All protocols observed, but having recently been made a traditional chief, I have to acknowledge the Igwe Mbeukwu. because this is not Professor Buono you used to know. Well, actually, I want to cheer you up a bit because we are mourning, I know we are mourning a doyen of medicine. We have heard his lifestyle, his lifetime, and from a very close friend, Pius. You were in Edinburgh in 1982 at the Western Royal. I was there in 1982 at the Royal College for Sick Children, but I never met you. Why? Anyway, here we are.
Correction, please. I danced with you at a party in Edinburgh.
Was the reaction I was expecting. Yes. So this is what the reaction I was expecting. So to bring you people back to life, all right? Because yes, we are mourning him, but there is hardly any doctor or anybody like him in this Nigeria, in our domain. So thank you. I don't want the geriatricians to think that I've gone senile. But I remember, yes, I danced with you. Now, I put down a few things, but you've talked about his life. When such a thing happens, the preachers always say, "Kamado na kwa mado ko na kwa." So we should all be in searching, soul searching, and ask ourselves, if we went today, what would be said of us? And actually, he went suddenly. And when somebody called me to tell me that Professor Mbono, that I spoke with the week before, was dead, he asked me, "Bianne, imamo rapture?" Mwese ake nkebo rapture? You know, I know I'm a Christian and all. Same if we have yagi on descent. So I started tidying myself up. Because as Dr. Benebe will testify, I don't think, and you, Gashon, I don't think I will not merit it. But the idea is to work towards it, to leave a legacy, to be good and to see everything. And you have seen from all over the world, people have responded. Whether he drove a private jet or anything, does it matter now? No. And like, I live in Onitsha. So one businessman came and asked me, "Be a professor. Akuku ono na agodo na emenke professor professor inwa nwa yo ga bu professor mana anyi nwa diego anyi nwa na anya rapulu mu anyi ego nwese agi na ewe emezi. So all is vanity. Yes, without God, without Christ, with your good will, good deeds, you will be judged. So I say to Professor Mbono's family, and please convey this to Vero, my sister, that your father's good works and your father's good will go with you. Wherever they hear that you are his children, his relations, people will respect and do whatever you want to be done for you, because he was kind and nice to people." So as I knew him, we were students together at UI. Mr. Chairman, I know you are all gray, but you were a year my junior in the medical school. And I wonder, since we went, and I came with a friend who was there with us at the University of Ibadan, although she read English, but she read English, and she's a retired principal and supervisor of schools. So she accompanied me because we all knew one another when we were there. And we were very close, all of us, because of the situation in the country then. It's like something that is happening now. So I wonder, suppose he didn't go to UI, would he have been so good? So, great you are. So I believe our university had a lot to do with it, and his home had a lot to do with it. So on behalf of the UITs, of our general friends, and he's talked of friends, and he didn't mention Dr. Innocent Onyewutu, who is his twin, they are inseparable. So on behalf of all of us, I am saying it is well, all right? It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Okay. Great, great, Ify, that great tribute. Please, Professor J.C. Orakwe, please.
I have to come here because I was mentioned severally by the lecturer. Now, I'm lucky because one is that they warned us that we must not talk more than 3 minutes late. And it is very difficult, it will be very difficult for me to talk in 3 minutes about my relationship with Professor Mbonu. Secondly, is that the lecturer had said everything that should be said. So if I have to say anything, it's just to top up, like they say it. But you know, tributes of somebody like Professor Mbonu mimics that proverbial meeting of the 7 blind men of an elephant. They all touched different parts of the elephant and were reporting what they find. They think the elephant was like. All of them were correct. Though diversive in their descriptions, and that is Professor K. Mbonu. You have different ways of describing him. I won't go into the details again of how we met, but that was too in UNTH. I came from my residency program and went to his office, unlike that of P.I.S. Okafor. Mine was not direct entry. I went to his office and saw this very young man who they say was in charge of residency and posting of residents. So I sat down with him, and in fact, I didn't know what I was doing that day because he was so full of humor. And looking at him was every inch admirable. Is it his robust physique or his bouncing gait? If you look at him, most like Professor Mbonu. But something must have happened that way, like Jung said, that when two people meet, it's like the meeting of two chemical substances. And if those substances react, then both of you will be transformed. I think my meeting with Mbonu that day transformed me markedly, because from that day, I started being endeared to Professor Mbonu. And somehow, I think also, that Professor Mbano got endeared to me by subsequent events that happened. Now, when in the course of our residency program, it was time to choose our subspecialty. Of course, I didn't think twice before I chose urology. I just walked to Professor Mbano's office and said, please, sir, can I join you in urology? Right away, he said, there was no thinking about it. And subsequently, he arranged my training like the guest speaker in Professor Chisholm's unit in Edinburgh. I came back from Edinburgh, and the story continues until I became a professor of surgery and consultant urologist, retired professor of surgery and consultant urologist. He said something which he did not emphasize. PIS, Arape, and so on. We were known as Mbano Boys in UNTH. This is because of it was a sobriquet they gave us in UNTH. This was because of the perceived influence Mbano had on us. PIS, JC Orakwe, and Zander Wonfo, who were the first set of Mbano boys. Subsequently, a lot of others cropped up. But I must say a few things about Mbano, which I know. I don't mind. One of the things is his leadership style, which has been emphasized, democratic and transformational. You cannot work with Mbano or do anything without him, without contributing. He getting you to contribute something. He believes, he respects superior argument and everything. And he's never obstinate about his own ideas and beliefs. And whenever he has, a few, one or two times I had him, I was with him, and I saw he insisted that something must be done, even though every other person was outside. Subsequently, we discovered that his stubbornness was not only progressive, but now, let me not talk further, but one thing again that I want us to believe is this, that from history, there has been no public figure that is completely good. Some are mostly good with little bad, while others are mostly bad with little good. That's fair enough. But for Professor Mbano, I dare say, and I quote, behold an Israelite in whom there is no guile. That is the man Mbano. John Drinkwater, those of you who are literally inclined, in his book Abraham Lincoln, did write, and I quote, when the high hearts we magnify and sure vision celebrate, and watch greatness passing by, ourselves are great. I feel great, and I believe all of us feel great for being here to be part of this honor for a great man, Emeritus Professor O.O. Mbano, who was my master, my mentor, and my friend. That is Oko Mbano. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, we have about 10 more people to give tributes. Therefore, you kindly make it brief. I think it's going to be, I won't use the word unethical, but it would be bad for me to just stop you in the middle of it. So please try and summarize things, because, I mean, most of the things we are all talking about have been said. The next guy here is Professor S.N.C. Anyanwu, please.
Chairman, sir, I will speak from perspective of this hospital, being the oldest member of staff of this hospital. I joined here on June 23, 1989, then the Asotec. We are supposed to have the hospital, which took time. In fact, I signed the handover of the hospital from the Minister of Health, from Dr. Igbokwe, who was the last medical officer in charge. Professor Zilo was our provost and chief medical director for about 2 years. But we had a lot of issues with him. When Dr. Ken Bonoden was appointed by Anambra State government as medical director, many of us were happy. One reason being that he was a clinician, unlike Ezilo, and we felt he will change practice in the hospital. And they also separated the office of the provost and the CMD. Of course, I had known Dr. Mbon. I did my S1 under him in 1977. So when Professor Mbon came, we had a lot of expectations of him. And I will say he fully met our expectations. I will just mention a few. He restructured function in the hospital that it will build around consultants, unlike the medical officer plan in General Hospital, where every doctor is on his own. Professor Mbono was active in what we call the town and gown collaboration. He had Louis Carter, Ibeto, all prominent Nnewi people to endow, when money was not coming from anywhere, to endow buildings which we used. Professor Mbonu took ownership of permanent sites and initiated the fencing of that site, knowing that we have to move with time. Professor Mbono established a strong collaboration between university, college, and hospital. Nobody ever had any disagreement as of then. Unlike now, where if you're a university staff, no light for you from the hospital and vice versa. Professor Mbono, like I've been mentioned, can relate with any person, both old and young. I will call you by name and remember everything about you. When I was a resident, I didn't train under him, but he was my friend. Many of those places, Professor Pierre, the cover mentioned, where he used to go and moonlight, he will send a call, and he will come and take me to this place. And I will take him there. No questions asked. No, I didn't join him in surgery. We also had other relationships on a social scale, which nobody had mentioned. Many of us didn't realize that Professor Mbono was a barrack person. He was responsive to authority. Mbono will never challenge any authority in life. But much later, we learned that he grew up in the prison barracks. So he wasn't a union person, but he supported all the unions. When I was MDCAN chairman and then became national president, all the support we had, he gave us all, any meeting we go, he would give us a vehicle and support us to go. In fact, when you go outside there, there's a lunch there, which Professor Bono built for consultants to stay because the university could not provide us with any offices to stay. When the NAD crisis of 1999 came, we know how we resolved it. The killing themselves here for office. And Professor Mbonu played an active part. Now, to the those in office, Professor Mbonu was a man of due process. Professor Okafo mentioned how he was interviewed. If the three people from surgery were not at that interview panel, which Dr. Obiekwe was chair of, not Professor Mbonu, that process would not have taken place. Professor Mbonu never employed anybody outside the realms of department and officialdom. He was strictly due process all his life. All agencies here had their powers and due process. The Drug Revolving Fund, which established Theatre Address Committee, everybody was doing his work according to the guidelines. So many of us look forward to the name he brought to us here. We supported him. We campaigned for him to be whatever office. He never campaigned for any office himself. It was us, junior people, who went around the country, particularly Aloy Ayaji and myself, campaigning for him to be chairman of Faculty of Surgery and the president of West Africa College of Surgeons. When Mbonu retired, he's still associated with us. Anytime he sees you, he will talk to you. So in my obituary to Professor Mbonu, I wrote Professor Mbonu, a good man. And I still stand on that. Mr. Chairman, thank you.
Thank you. We're making progress. Professor Prince Ele, please.
Maybe I should say something from here. And I assure you, Mr. Chairman, I will speak for less than 3 minutes. Yeah. Listening to that scintillating lecture by P.S. Okafor, I think everything that needs to be said has really been said. And I have just 4 words to capture what I think about our beloved Mbonu. Number one, Mbonu was truly legendary. If you know the meaning of the word legend, Mbonu was a legendary personality, known all over Nigeria. In Yoruba land, he was popular. In Hausa land, he was popular. In the South, South, Southeast, and internationally. Everybody seemed to be happy with Mbonu. To that extent, he was really a legend. Professor Mbonu, the second word, Mbonu was an icon, a true icon. An icon is symbolic of something special. If you wanted to talk about goodness, that's Mbonu. If you wanted to talk about kindness, that's Mbonu. If you wanted to talk about caring, that's Mbonu. If you wanted to talk about thoughtfulness, helpfulness, that's Mbonu. Mbonu, like the lecturer mentioned, will always ask you about yourself and your family. And 3-4 months afterwards, he will see you and say, how did that thing go? That's Mbonu. Mbonu was truly an icon representing everything good. The third word I want to use, Mbonu was altruistic. He was an altruistic personality. Mbonu was someone who would relinquish his comfort for the well-being of another person. Those of you who know Mbonu, that's Mbonu. And this last one,
I thought about this. We are all ordinary citizens, but here we are gathered to ruminate on someone who was extraordinary. Mbono was an extraordinary personality, and his impact was profound. He made profound impact on the big, on the small, on the lay, on the professional. Everywhere he went, Mbono was very, very impactful. A quality that is not common to find amongst ordinary people. And to that extent, Mbono was truly extraordinary. May the family be comforted, be strong, and be courageous. That's something the guest lecturer said, which caught my attention. Mbono did not die. Mbono did not die. He lives on, and he has left a legacy. And I've asked myself, if I pass on, what will people think about me? What will people be saying about me? So I want to encourage all of us. He has left a legacy that is worth emulating. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Please, again, I plead that we try and keep to time. We've got a lot of other guys who want to speak. And if we overshoot as we're doing, we're probably not going to leave here today. I'd like to call Professor M.C. Mosu. Professor M.C. Mosu, please. Give me a hand.
Mr. Chairman, all protocols observed. Mine is going to be really, really short. According to Professor Nwanko, speeches should be according to sizes. Professor Mbono, the only word I would see is that he's a man who tells too much of the truth. You can never find him telling anything that is falsehood. In everything he has done, in his practice, in his relationship with his fellow men, and otherwise. I say this because of the great impact he had on me when I lost my dear wife. He was the one person who told me the truth that I'll never forget. And for that, I held him there very close to my heart. But every time we see, we still share that memory. I will not say much more than this. But Professor Mbono is a real human being with humanity in him. I say to his family, may the good Lord comfort you and give you all you need to withstand the problems that you may face as a result of his demise. Thank you.
Progress, Professor A.M.E. Nwafor.
Chairman, sir, ladies and gentlemen, well, there's not much to be said again after this detailed lecture. The only thing I have to say is that this is a good man and we have lost him. He's put up a lot of legacies, which we shall try to keep. And I will promise you that the much we can do is to keep his legacies. And then all of us should be consoled, especially the family. May his soul rest in peace.
Good. We're making progress. M.D. Khan, chairman, is he around?
Thank you, the chairman and the chief medical director. I'm standing on the same protocol. I just want to say that all the people who have been speaking are either MDCAN's members currently or the past members whom have sent forth. So I'm just going to cap what they have said, not to say more. But to say that of Mbono, we have lost a father, a great teacher, a very intelligent and smart personality, if you have sat down with him, and a father figure, and one who provides us with a basis to interact with other people under centers. When you mention Newi, I say where it is, you have to hear about Mbono. So he gives us, he places us on the map. We're going to miss him for all the fatherly advice and provision he offers us. Our MDCAN lad was him who provided us chief medical director until Oshinamata touched it again. So we miss him and the families. I believe that what we have been said here about him would console them and know that they have a father who is larger than they could imagine, and it should start the consolation and a motivation for them to truly follow his legacy and think about what they will leave behind for him. Thank you.
Professor Ofiedi, please. R. Ofiedi.
Please, I want to reserve my comments till tomorrow. I'll be speaking at Naut ceremony tomorrow on Professor Mbono. Okay? Thank you.
Okay, Professor Ezra Nolo, please.
Mr. Chairman, all protocols observed. You say we speak for 3 minutes. I looked at my relationship with Professor Mbono, starting from my medical student days in the 70s till November 2023. It's quite a long time, but be that as it may, I will skip a few things I wanted to say. And said that I met him as a medical student. I did a posting under his unit. And thereafter, I became his house officer. And that was when somebody made a comment. If I know somebody, let me say the person. Reverend Sister Dr. Tumi of Mata Hospital, Afikpo. Because there was an arrangement for me to walk. Please, can you give us slide 6 from PIS Okafor lecture, please? I was scheduled to go to Mata Hospital on a special assignment to help them in their ONG as a house officer. So because of that, I was scheduled. The hospital said I must do general surgery before. In fact, it was Mata that requested that I should do general surgery before coming to Mata for ONG. And I was posted to Mbono's unit. And the Reverend Dr. Tumi, the Irish Reverend Sister, who was in charge of Mata Hospital, came into UNTH. And we talked, I agreed on the visit. And I said, I'm with Professor Mbono, then Dr. Mbono. He said, that gentleman. She now narrated how Mbono evacuated Biafra wounded soldiers from Mata Hospital at the time the federal troops crossed Itigidi, the cross river, and was invading Afiafibo. That night, he said Mbono led the Biafra medical evacuation team into Mata Hospital and moved all wounded Biafran troops they are attending to safety. And not after 1 hour, they completed the evacuation, the federal troops stormed Mata Hospital. And she was there in the labor ward, trying to hold them. Anyway, that's a long story for another day, but that's the kind of testimony I had from him. But there was his house officer. Then that made me to look closely, and behold, Mbono had always been there for me, as a medical student, as a house officer, as a consultant, and as an MDCAN chairman in UNTH, when we had crisis, Mbono was the chairman of board. He was a man of peace. He made sure that I sheathed my sword. Oh, you won't believe it. I was ready for the fight to finish. But he calmed me down. We talked and talked, and he negotiated peace. Not this Hamas and let me come back to you now. Mbono was instrumental to setting up of the ENT department in Nautia. At that time, medical students were being posted from here to Enugu for their postings. And then, of course, we had some issues about settlement, paying for their for extra labor, this academic allowance, extra load. And then we came to a point that it was becoming tough. So Professor Mbono and the Professor Nwako, as the Vice Chancellor, conspired that I should come to take a full-time job here. I was lecturer one. I said this in my valedictory lecture in his presence on 10th November. They now conspired and decided that I should be made direct senior lecturer so that I can leave UNT, University of Nigeria, come down to Nebu. I had other considerations. It was enticing, but we negotiated. At the end of the day, they agreed that I should come part-time. I think Eli and Adema should tell more story about this issue. In fact, they sent Adema to come and carry me physically from Enugu to. Anyway, that was the origin of setting up of the part-time, and that practice had remained there. When they said somebody was joking, and they said, I said, don't worry, we'll sort it out. We can do that. We have able-bodied people here, even though I'm visiting, but we have those on ground who will do it. What can I say about OO? At that time, there was first casting that coming to Navy was becoming a problem just to fuel. He quickly arranged, sent 25-liter fuel to me in Enugu to use to come down to Navy. I have to stop. I have a lot to say. But let me go down to the valedictory lecture. Luckily for me, I had a valedictory lecture at Enugu on 10th November, and Professor Owo was physically there with his wife. If you remember, you are talking of 10th November, and this thing happened on the 4th, since 4 days later. I was in shock. And in fact, for the family, please forgive me. I've not had the courage to call the wife, because the wife was there. I've not had the courage to call her to say, look, is this true? But I've been receiving condolences even more than new family members from those of us in Enugu, because they said, how can he was there for you? For him to come down to Enugu, stay with us in the morning, stay with us late into the night, he must be close to you, and I believe we are. They say my time is up. I have a lot to say, but let me stop so far. Please, my condolences to everybody. May you still rest in peace.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. How about this? Please, Professor Igwebe, immediate past CMD.
I think I'll stand here. The chairman, Professor Jekam, you remember when you were students, where you tell us that a chanka is a chanka, even in a... a chanka is always a chanka, even in a... I will say, I will complete that one. So, welcome to Newi. I'm glad to see you after so many years. Ochinawata, Jidewa Kiji, PIS, I didn't know your name is Sunday. Today, come on, not Sunday. The S in it, all protocols observed. I'm standing to pay tribute. It's a short one to our father, mentor, teacher, everything. All has been said by Professor P.I.S. Okay, but you just have to add a little thing personal. I would say that Professor Mbono was student friendly. I recall in our student days at the Enugu campus, that I was the vice hall chairman and he was the hall warden. We used to go to his house in the Enugu campus to have small, short meetings. And the way he received us, entertain us, you will not know the difference between himself and the student. Also, when we miss buses from Enugu campus to the university, to the hospital, we always wait along a tree there to wait for lecturers who will give us lifts. Some will come and go without looking at the students, but Mbono will always stop with his red 504 to pick all the students available, even carrying overload. He will always help us. Go coming to his clinic, Friday's clinic. We don't forget his Friday's clinic. Always full. If you don't come in time, you don't have a space. I recall he will tell us how to palpate the prostate. He will bring his models. This is the way the the normal one fields, and this is the one that has deposit fields. So all of that, he was just very friendly to all of us, to students. And in the exams, Professor Pierce has said it, every student will want to be examined by Professor Mbon. Because if you fail, then you know that you don't know anything. So we were always praying, if possible, to sort others that will be put in the section where Professor, the team where Professor Mbon will be. So that was Professor, he will teach you very well. And I was also privileged to work as a house officer under his unit with Araj. He was very active. By that time, PIS has left. We were there with Araj. So coming here in to Naut, I say that he accepted me as a consultant, immediately applied on the ground that I must leave Nnewi. I reassured him that I would leave Nnewi. And he said, okay, there's no problem. I was given an appointment later as a consultant. Then I says, yes, in the management, anytime time before when we are going for the interview for the post of CMD, he called me, gave me some questions. These are the things you might be asked, this and that, and just give me some tips, which turned out to be very, very valuable and instrumental to the position. Also, I will not forget as no, as an experienced person, you need to give you some tips, the questions, likely questions, and also it's not expo, because he was number. So, I recall even as CMD, I used to go to him anytime I have one or two issues, and he comes to me anytime. During my first term, we had a lot of crisis with unions, strike, ARD, Johesu. That time, that was the time they formed the Johesu. They were just alternating strike. I remember one occasion, I was in 2016 or so, I was traveling to a conference with my wife to Vancouver, Canada for FIGO. I already arrived, just to have to pass the night in Abuja. Then another crisis at the teaching hospital, I think Johesu went on strike. NAD was already on strike. Johesu just joined, and then there was crisis in the hospital. I'd already received permission from minister. I called the director of hospital service, said that I have already received permission that I should continue with my trip. But that evening, Professor Mbon called me. When he asked me, are you still in Nigeria? I said, yes, I'm traveling this night. He advised me that it's better you come back. And I changed my trajectory. My wife wasn't happy, but I said I will have to come back, that this is coming from a man of wisdom. And it was a very good advice. Otherwise, okay. So that is Professor Mbon for you. He will always smart, and he will always be diplomatic. He will give you good advice. I will say, may his gentle soul rest in peace.
Amen, amen, amen. Well, we'll take one more. NMA, National President.
They're now.
Someone is representing him, yeah? NMA? Okay.
Yes, it's here. You cover me so that the president will know that I came here. Of course, you'll cover me now so that President will know that I was there. Mr. Chairman, Professor Jakam, I must appreciate you. The immediate past CMD was shy of saying in full what you said in those days. Tony, we are classmates, so are you taught us? You said a chanka is a chanka even on a Pope's prick. So that the Pope. The prick belongs to the Pope, doesn't bear the chanka, not to be a chanka. That's Professor Jakam. Professor Joe Baja, I appreciate you. I want to stand on the existing protocols, but I must appreciate Igwe Mbuku, Igwe Kigwe, Ezekeze, Igwe Anugu, Madiana, Anamekinegi, Asinaga, Adregimma. No. Let me really stand on existing protocols because I must finish in less than 3 minutes. Dr. Uche Ojimma, the president of Nigerian Medical Association, would have been here, but he has other engagements. It's the exigencies of the responsibilities on him that has made him not to be here. He is in the Senate in the investigative discussion on issues that we have. One is the treatment of gunshot injuries and emergencies, without talking about remunerations for such, you know, for such treatments. The other one is the strike by resident doctors, a way to make it impossible for resident doctors to be on strike. I'm sure this will interest some of the resident doctors here. So he's here to defend these causes. That is why he's not here. He has asked me to represent him. I'm also here as an individual, as a person, as Dr. Jide, student of Professor Okechukwu Obiora Mbonu. In those days, before I go to my personal experience with him, let me say what Dr. Ojimba would have said. And it would have been a very long speech, but Professor P.I.S. Okafor Babando, you shortened it when you said that Prof. Mbonu was a superlative family man. Ma, I appreciate you, my teacher. Thank you, Ma. Superlative family man. I want to remove the word family and say superlative man. That captures what Ojimba would have said if he were to be here. Because Mbonu was superlative in the academia, he was. In the association, Nigerian Medical Association, especially NMA Anambra State, that I had the opportunity and privilege to head, he was. Also in his relationship with other people, Mbonu was actually superlative. Let me go to something personal that happened when I was doing my posting. Tony Gwebe, I don't know whether you remember. You may not remember because probably you were not there then. We came out from the ward. Dr. Mbonu then was standing alone on the corridor of the surgical ward. Meanwhile, Dr. Eguatu, V.E. Eguatu, was standing a distance away with people around him, discussing, chatting, men with their wives. You know, some obviously pregnant, some not obviously pregnant. Chatting, they were happy. But Mbonu was standing alone. And a colleague, I can't remember who exactly now, approached him and said, Chief, I said, this is the bane of urologists. That if somebody comes here to chat with me now, somebody will think he has an ulcer or a leaking pipe. That was what everyone said. People would not want to come and chat with him so that others will not misunderstand the relationship, that he has an ulcer or a leaking pipe. I said, sure. This my teacher was afraid of, can be so jocular, so jovial, so humorous. And that attracted me to him. And honestly, there has been no gap, no stopping of this relationship until now. It's only death that has removed Mbonu from me. But I still remember him, I'll never forget him. And I say that may his gentle soul rest in peace.
You've no. Well, I'm manager with the alignment better. I have two everybody's there, so if I'm going to fall, they're going to catch me. I wish to thank everybody at spare time to come here today. It's not easy. Some of us left our location 6 o'clock in the morning to be here on time. And I thank all of you. Okay, Mbonu deserves every honor that anybody could give him. Like I said, I'm here to find one person who has something wrong to say about him. I'm one of his beneficiaries. When I went to Orawa in 1974, he harbored me in his house for 3 months while I was waiting to get my own apartment. And that was very generous of him. And then, of course, my little girl, Ngozi, is my goddaughter with my wife. So it's like family. And we'll never forget that. But the only story I want to tell is that he's a nice chap, but he can be violent when it's necessary. And I tell you the story. At Ogun Joint Hospital, when we were evacuating the hospital, as we were there, under Dr. Mbanefo, the surgeon, okay, was there, and the other chaps were there. I was a medical student working with them. Captain Achuzia came over and told us to leave the place immediately, that Nigerian troops were lobbing sheriffs all over. And you could hear the sheriffs leaving. I, as a junior person, ran to the ward, got all the patients who are ambulance to move, walk, start walking to Okigwe. But I got one of our chaps who was very good. Those who couldn't move, he had a 544. He was moving to Okigwe and back in unbelievable time. But the story is coming. Now, when we finished and everybody had left, it was me and Dr. Mbono and his driver. And then there was one nurse who wanted to join us in our car. And you know what happened? As we were about to drive, the sheriff was coming. This girl tried to open the door to jump out to go and bring her rosary. She forgot. So from behind, Mbono gave her a big slap and she fell back into the car and we drove off. And that saved us. Because if we had stayed there to go and get rosary and back, we don't know what would happen to us. This is a true story. So we have to mourn, like they say, the children are grown, they know what their father has done, and all we can tell them to be like your father. You'll be doing him a big credit. Then the next symbol, vote of thanks.
We are supposed to take the spoof, but we are skipping it for want of time. So to realign the program to our timing, which is just a few minutes to 2 o'clock. Okwa John, yeah? We have gotten to the traditional pinnacle of this very beautiful event. Suddenly, a very painful and lugubrious event has been made a very lively and joyous one. And the lecturer had to remind us that matter can neither be destroyed nor created. Rather, matter can be changed from one form to the other. He tells us again that when a good man dies, he doesn't just vanish. He doesn't die. He just tries to transform or transcend from one lower form to a much higher form. So I can see there are no tears anymore. I can see so many smiles and cheers. And that's the goodwill of what our elders and friends have just done. I got na dike ni kengia. Okwa jaga akwa la nyoja. Non nuku dike ka akwa tulefa. So CMD in hospital management, with the combination of Eze Amusu, Eze Boya, and my Okwa Chukwu, Eze Amusu continue kwa na esike. Makenwere ebe Eze Amusu no, Professor Mbono anoro. Every trip they make, he's always there. When I talk with them on video, I hand it over to the wife. Koma lukwa na fano mwa ebe fano no budo ibo. So kita osa osi aga akuzi. Etu urologist ya akuzi osofa. Okwa oja. Ige emela ife na emedike. Makana. Yadiba. Thank you. biko ka akunita aka na okwa oja di egwu and if oja ji mamma bu na if oja ji we mamma bu na professor ken wogu si na nne agwalia ego ne ka na enye okwa oja o we gbuo na ebenebe egbuo na ebenebe onya meli feba we kebo the cheapest invite ya inwele ba and all the tradition of Ndibo, kai we say professor mbon ya je nkoma chairman sir vote of thanks
we'd like to invite a member of the family of professor mbon to say a few words. We understand that you would like to chip in a few words there, please.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Bumneme Chinaya Mbono, the second son of Professor Emeritus Bono. I'd like to say a few words, a vote of thanks to the Nayuth management for setting this up, CMD, Professor Obaja Uchinawata Newi. Thank you very much, sir. Our royal father, His Royal Majesty Igwe JP Anugu, our second father, Ezukumbaku. I like to observe my uncles, Uncle Geshon Ejekam, and Uncle P.I.S. Okafo, Uncle Zanta Wonfo. Thank you for being there during this period, trying period. We appreciate you. And everyone that has played a pivotal role during this difficult time. On behalf of my family and myself and my mother, we say thank you. I'd like to thank everyone that has played a big role here, and then may God bless you as we close off today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Mr. Bunneme Chinenye Mbono. He has been like the go-between. When Professor KDT Yahweh said, Professor Emejulu, where are you? I said, I'm somewhere in Abuja. I'm coming down from Kano. He said, have you heard anything about Professor Mbono? I said, no. He said, I should call his number now. For the first time in my life, Obunneme picked. That was where I could not continue with the discussion. And he's been at his feet since then till now. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gradually winding down, and we thank you all for your attention, cooperation. Nobody seems to have felt uncomfortable. Even though now standing ACs are the Okwankona Lol, man, weather, Maka. God bless this weather for us. And we're having a great day indeed. So, yes. Okay. So can I call on the director of admin to come and speak to the world about the feelings of the hospital as a whole about this very painful event in our comments?
Thank you, Ebu Compare. My CMD, I'm going to stand on already established protocol. I have a very simple job: to say thank you for everyone that has come. I want to say thank you to the CMD, Kachisi Eme Amaka, Ifeomeji Amatu, God's gift to Naut. You know, immediately Professor Mbono passed on, his first desire was to give him a very befitting burial. So he put in place a high-powered management committee to ensure that that is done. And that is what we are seeing today. CMD, sir, thank you so much. I also want to thank the chairman of the occasion, Professor Ejekam. Thank you very much, sir. I know you're very close to Professor Mbono. Thank you for coming, sir. To the public lecturer, hi, I don't know what to say. You did a very marvelous job. In fact, on the platform, the committee platform, I saw somebody said that the public lecturer is a round peg in a round hole. You did a very marvelous job. Our okay, apart CMDs, Professor Aruofieli, Professor Egwebe, thank you, the rep of, I think her name is, thank you for coming. Our professors who have retired, we are so glad to see you. Thank God that this brought you here. Thank you for coming. To the children, you've heard what, you know, different people have spoken about your daddy. Your daddy was simply a legend. He was a colossus. He was a giant, a dawn of surgery. In fact, I'll just leave you with this Anglican song that says, you people are going to reap in a millionfold what your daddy has sown in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He was a great man. He had just translated to glory. And I even thank God the way he translated. Painlessly. That was the man he was. Very caring. Just like others said, Omo everybody by name, Ofora Anage, he would always say something that would put a smile to your face. He was very special to me, very dear to me. So I want to thank everybody that has come to grace this occasion. Even as we go back, I pray the good Lord to lead us back to our different destinations in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Please, a little announcement. After this, at the end of this public lecture, the professors and the HODs, please, you go to the boardroom. We have a little entertainment for you. Others, please, you wait in this auditorium. Everybody must eat before going home. Thank you so much. Thank you, my sim. Tomorrow. You know, tomorrow we have the commendation service at the quadrangle. Please, everybody should be there. Let's pay. Okay. Please, you know, be in your gowns, academic gown, to pay farewell to our late dawn of surgery. Thank you very much. God bless all of us. Amen.
Please, Camry Black, Abuja, ABC795GY is blocking Ezamusu now. Biko, and Mayo Biko. Let the driver of that Camry, Abuja Black, ABC795GY, Konyelo Nwiaka. So we take the closing remarks by the chairman, Professor Kesho. Mrs. Rita Ikanyong, Deputy Director, Clinical Services.
Ladies and gentlemen, the deed is done. And I think if you have to pat yourself at the back, I think mission accomplished. I thank everyone that's been able to be here today. It's not a joyous thing, but we have no choice. We have to do it. Everybody's a mourner, but but we can't do much about it. Ndị na-anya moto like me, nwa sofu bottle. Ka maka iwele ibu ọ na-eto inwe ike, he ma fuzi ebere odudi. So take it easy. May God take us back safely to our respective homes. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Kedụ onye ga-ekpele anyị ekpele, biko ka anyị kwuru ntọtọ ka o kpee ekpele.
Shall we pray, please? In Jesus' name we pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we want to sincerely appreciate you, O God, for what you have done unto us this day. Thank you for bringing us all the way from our different destinations up to this very moment. Thank you for what we learned concerning the life and times of our own daddy, Professor Ounbono. Thank you because I know that you will always continue with us. As we're about to leave, O God, we pray and ask that your grace, that your mercy will continue to sustain us. As we go back to our different homes, we pray for journey mercies. Take us back safely to the glory of your holy name. In Jesus' name we sincerely pray. Amen.
Rendition by our choir. Proceed. So procession retreat will be in reverse order. Thank you so much.
In this place you find there's no strong, it only cares for joyful giving. If we try, we shall see. In this place we cannot feel. Fear of death, we stop existing and start living. Oh.
And it feels like always, love's in us for growing. Make a little space, make a better place. Make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. Make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world. Make it a better place for you.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love.